All right. Hello, everybody. Rob Bauer, broadcasting live from Thibodaux, Louisiana tonight, joined by my partner in crime, T-Ben Thompson. How you doing, T-Ben?
I'm doing great.
T-Ben, we're very excited about a regional playoff matchup tonight where the EDY Cardinals are going to take on the De La Salle Cavaliers. But before we get into our pregame, we'd like to take a few moments and listen to the coaches talk about the upcoming game.
Sounds good.
Yeah, we're very excited to play here at EDY. EDY's a great team. This is an unbelievable matchup. Not the matchup you expect in the second round. Watching film on EDY, they run offense and defense as well as I've seen high school players do it. They all fly to the ball. They're very, very well coached. We are very excited to play this game. Tough season. Had a very tough pre-district or non-district schedule. But I think our kids are battle-tested. We've played very good teams in the city. Holy Cross, the number one seed in Division I, St. Charles Catholic, St. Aug, teams like this, St. Paul's. So we feel like we're battle-tested, but we'll see. You know, it's playoff football, so we're hoping that our kids make just enough good plays to win the game.
Hey, we're excited to get back to football after having a week off. We're able to heal up a little bit over the week. Got a great football team coming in De La Salle, so it's going to take a great effort tonight. Best of luck to our guys. Hopefully we stay healthy. Hopefully you play well, protect the football, keep the football in our possession, and don't give up any big plays. So if we do those things, we'll have a chance in the fourth quarter. So enjoy the game, and hopefully we'll see you next week.
All right, some great comments from Coach Jarrett and Coach Kyle Lesang. Now we'll go ahead and take a few moments and have our weekly segment Outside the Box with Bubba Hebert.
Welcome back to this week's episode of Outside the Box with Bubba Hebert, previewing the regional round of the playoffs for the EDY Cardinals. The Cardinals capped off a perfect season with a victory over St. James 27-19 to capture the district title 2 weeks ago. After a week of R&R, the Cardinals will host the De La Salle Cavaliers, who shut out Buckeye 42-0 last week in the opening round of the playoffs. The Cavaliers are led by Coach Graham Jarrett in his 22nd year coaching and his third as head coach leading his alma mater. He's also a graduate of Nichols, where he played offensive line for the Colonels. The Cavaliers are 5-6 on the year, but were undefeated in district play with a tough out-of-district schedule, including four losses to teams with at least 8 wins on the year. I believe this is one of those cases where the athletes are better than the record indicates. The offense, averaging 26 points per game, is in the shotgun exclusively and is a spread-based offense with a near 50-50 split of run and pass. The offense is led by number 10 junior quarterback Evan Arsenault, who completes 55% of his passes for 148 yards per game with 11 touchdowns and 7 picks on the year. Not a threat running the ball at all. Is nowhere near the running threat the quarterbacks for the last 2 weeks we face, as he's rushed for negative yards on the year. He showed good command of the offense and confidence in his arm as he has matured throughout the year. The ground game averages 169 yards per game, and you will see some zone and power lead blocking principles behind a revamped offensive line that averages 6 foot 240 pounds. The running back room is led by number 4 junior Jason Banks at 5'10", 200 pounds. He leads the team with 11 touchdowns and averages nearly 6 yards per carry. Number 8 Kobe Pounds at 5'10", 180 pounds is second on the team in carries. You will see him in the slot and sometimes in the backfield, the wing position. Out wide, you'll see number 5 Jace Bieniemy, 14 Brant Haynes, 13 LeVar Fortenberry, who leads the team in touchdown receptions. The defense is very similar to St. James in that they are really multiple. It looks like they have a base 4-3 against run-heavy teams, which is, I suppose, what we'll see for the vast majority of the night. They drop a linebacker in passing downs and move into a 4-2-5 like most people do. They have shown some odd fronts with 3-3 look as well, so expect them all over the place. The engine behind the defense is number 11, Kidrick Richardson, a 5'11", 220-pound veteran middle linebacker who's been playing so long they call him Paw Paw. Coach Jarrett referenced him as the defensive leader for a long time. He's compact, runs well, and is a great tackler. He averages just over 10 tackles per game. He's flanked by number 6, Troy Williams, and number 1, Derek Irvin, who's the drop linebacker safety hybrid when they go to the nickel package. His safety mate is number two, Montez Randall, who, like Irvin, is athletic and a good tackler in space. These safeties make a lot of tackles behind the tackling machine middle linebacker. He's got 108 tackles on the year. That's absurd. A defensive end is number nine, Timothy Maxson, a 6'2", 260-pound man who sets the edge and leads the team in sacks. In the middle of the nine is number 99, Jaden Ellie, a 6'2", 260-pounder who likes to push the pocket and get some penetration and be disruptive in the quarterback's face. He's joined by a longer, leaner sidekick, number 55, Austin Young, at 6'4", 250. They have good athletes on defense for sure, but they've been prone to giving up points as they've given up nearly 35 points a game in their losses. They were completely dominant last week against Buckeye, who was trying to punch way above their weight class. The Cardinals won a hard-fought battle that was back and forth for the majority of the game. It was highlighted by big electric plays from both teams all night long. Not an easy place to go and win. And another great test passed on the way to the playoffs. The Cardinals leaned on their veteran leader, Uncle Jake Sternfels, who led the offense with 103 yards rushing and a beautiful touchdown where he laid out and got horizontal to break the play. He is so efficient with his reads. I mean, he's able to steal yards at each option with his delayed reads and last-minute quick decisions. It's impressive. Carter Douglas led the scoring with three touchdowns. That's six tutters for Carter in the last 3 weeks. The leading receiver was, shocker, Paxton LaFont, 80 yards, long of 43. The defense had another great week, holding St. James to their lowest scoring output of the year. Like most games against the Wildcats, there's going to be some kind of sports center highlight due to the dynamic athletes. They tend to grow in Vashry. And while we saw our fair share of those, the D was nails when it needed. Great regular season defense, 12.5 points a game surrendered. As the regular season has commenced and we've all rested and recovered from our bye week, the focus ramps up a notch as we all realize the inevitability of the win or go home scenario is upon us. The dress rehearsal is over. It's time for the real show. The lights are a little bit brighter. The cheer is a little bit louder, but the stakes go through the roof. Every little thing matters and could decide the fate of some of your teammates' entire career. Look, I know I'm being a little dramatic, but hey, it's a big deal. For most of our seniors, it could potentially be the last time they take the field or put a Cardinal uniform on. All the blood, sweat, and tears poured into our sport we all love so dearly can be taken away. Just like that. It's time to lock in and focus for 48 minutes. Laser focus. Don't get out your game plan. Nobody's been able to stop you yet. Protect the football. Limit the penalties. Defense, follow your keys. Play fast. Use your speed and instincts. Be nasty. Get after the quarterback. He's not the most elusive gunslinger we've seen. Cause turnovers. Do what you do best. Speaking of, we haven't seen you guys score in a few weeks, if I remember right. Wouldn't be a bad time to start that back up. Just saying. The offense, as we have heard from nearly every single opposing coach all year, is that we are difficult to plan for. Both scheme and so many viable options on the ground and through the air. In other words, stick to your game plan. The O-line is going to have to be solid. Their front seven has good size and athleticism. I believe the defense is up to the challenge based on how they've handled the athletes they have faced over the last few weeks. If each team comes out and executes their game plan, I still like the Cardinals. Too complete a team for me to pick against them, especially in Peltier Stadium. You defend your home with your life. It's not time to rest on your laurels. Strap it on, lock it in, and get ready for a fight. The road to the Dome starts Friday night. Roll on, Red Machine.
Thank you so much, Bubba. This has been a great segment he's been putting on all season long. Appreciate that. Up next, let's recognize our season-long presenting sponsor.
At Thibodaux Regional Wellness Center, we're improving the health and well-being of the region one person at a time. And this means more game time, more first times, more crunch time, more face time, and more party time. Isn't it time you started living your best life? Change starts here at Thibodaux Regional Wellness Center.
Thank you so much, Thibodaux Regional, for your season-long sponsorship. Up next, we'd like to recognize our season-long streaming partner, the Center for Pediatric Therapy.
For 17 years, the Center for Pediatric Therapy has proudly been the Bayou Region's only dedicated pediatric therapy clinic to offer all three major therapy disciplines. We provide pediatric speech, occupational, and physical therapy, and have a combined 135 years of pediatric therapy experience. Additionally, many of our speech and occupational therapists are cross-trained to offer feeding therapy. All of these services are provided in our spacious, company-owned facilities in both Houma and Thibodaux, in approved school settings or in homes of children aged 0 to 3 who are enrolled in the Early Steps program. If you feel like your child could benefit from any or all of our services, please call our friendly front office staff and they would be happy to answer all of your questions.
All right, thanks to Center for Pediatric Therapy for your season-long sponsorship of streaming. Up next, let's meet the Cardinals.
Noah Benoit, D-line.
Barry Boudry, quarterback. Joshua Courtright, wide receiver.
Jeffrey Dietrich, running back.
Andrew Douay, running back.
Matthew Escher, weak safety.
Paxton LaFont, wide receiver.
Evan Lejeune, linebacker.
Jensen Malasong, cornerback.
Jacob Olko, offensive tackle.
Landon Pornbuff, running back.
Foster Porsche, offensive line.
Cole Stagney, D-line.
Jake Sternfels, quarterback.
Jackson Taylor, wide receiver.
Michael Tenney, running back.
Taylor Thibodaux, linebacker.
Ty Thibodaux, cornerback.
Michael Beck, O-line.
Ben Blanchard, O-line.
Hugs Blanchard, O-line.
Tommy Bauer, offensive line.
Matthew Broussard, linebacker.
Jake Carrier, O-line.
Ben Guidry, quarterback.
Zach Gillen, O-line.
Bryce Hawley, safety.
Jackson Hebert, cornerback.
Phillip Hillman, tight end.
Governor Maurer, weak safety.
Hudson Allcow, O-line.
Grant Page, defensive end.
Cooper Passman, defensive tackle.
Ty Powell, specialist.
Tyler Pritchard, linebacker.
Max Richard, D-line.
Dylan Robichaud, strong safety.
Benjamin Rodrigue, running back.
Thomas Rosado, defensive tackle.
Aiden Saunier, wide receiver.
MJ Sternfels, linebacker.
Adam Talbot, defensive tackle.
Nate Thompson, free safety.
Jax Trish, strong safety.
Luke Trotty, defensive end.
Evan Weber, cornerback.
Luke Zerain, cornerback.
Seth Andrus, defensive tackle.
Cooper Andrews, offensive line.
Glenn Narby, defensive end.
Evan Arsenault, cornerback.
Landon Babin, cornerback.
Trey Babin, right tackle.
Grant Barbera, quarterback.
Cole Beaudien, wide receiver.
Marcel Benoit, safety.
Chris Bourgeois, safety.
Luke Cortez, defensive tackle.
Matt Cortez, O-line.
Charlie Dietrich, defensive end.
Carter Douglas, running back.
Alden Fields, linebacker.
Parker Hemel, cornerback.
Harrison Jones, D-line.
Jonathan Lee, linebacker.
Carter Myers, safety.
Chase Nakan, wide receiver.
Joseph Pisciola, right guard.
Owen Porsche, cornerback.
Jackson Richey, free safety.
Philip Roop, offensive line.
Hudson Simino, O-line.
Hayes Tabor, tight end.
All right, that's your 2023 EDY Cardinal lineup. We are, looks about 10 minutes or so from kickoff. T-Ben, how you feeling about tonight?
I was feeling good all week, but now that I was watching them warm up, I psyched myself out to get nervous.
Well, De La Salle is certainly a quality football team, and they have a storied history in New Orleans. And we went to New Orleans a few years ago, 3 or 4 years ago, and played De La Salle in the semifinals, and they really gave us the business. I can't remember what the score was, but it was pretty lopsided. It was a very tough team. We are thrilled to be able to host them here.
Yeah, no, De La Salle in the past has had a very good program and a couple of very good teams. And I know they're looking to get back. And I think the last couple of years they've been not quite as powerful as they had been, but they did go undefeated in the district at the end of the year, and they went on a run of consecutive victories to get into the playoffs. And they surely spanked that team they played last week.
Buckeye.
Yeah, Buckeye. They beat them pretty bad.
So, anyway, we're going to take a few minutes here, everybody. The Cardinals are going to run out, and De La Salle's going to run out. We're going to do our best with our one camera to try to catch both of the runouts tonight, and we're nearly 10 minutes away from kickoff. We're going to come back to you for the prayer, for the coin toss, and for the national anthem before we start the game. So, thanks, everybody, for tuning in, and we're looking forward to a great game tonight.
The Edie White fight song begins with spirit, will, spunk, fight. Cardinals fly high. And that's exactly what our mighty Cardinals have been doing for over 150 years. Edie White is a state-of-the-art co-educational institution serving Thibodaux and the surrounding area since 1855. For decades, Edie White students have been receiving a quality Catholic education under the guidance of the Brothers of the Sacred Heart, the Sisters of Mount Carmel, and dedicated lay teachers. Current students come to us from 38 different schools up and down Bayou Lafourche and Bayou Terrebonne and the lower part of the Mississippi River. Edie White students spread the word of God by participating in daily class lessons, class retreats, adoration of the Blessed Sacrament in our school's chapel, mission trips, and school-wide masses. Service to the church, home, and community is a way of life. Our students live out the gospel message through their commitment to helping those in our community through various clubs and organizations. We understand Catholic education is a financial obligation and a sacrifice. We accept 3 different state-sponsored scholarships in addition to our in-house tuition assistance program. If you would like to attend our open house and have a child in a non-diocesan school in Lafourche Parish or a school in another parish, please contact our Director of Admissions, Alicia Bajeron, via email for more information. The Cardinal spirit runs deep through our community. Come see what it's all about.
And here come your Edie White Cardinals. Got the flag in front tonight. Got an electric crowd here, full pack stadium. At Harvey Peltier Stadium and Yaki Bernard Field here. And you know the boys are fired up. And here come the Cavaliers coming out from New Orleans, our guests for tonight, for the game. Both teams seem very lively and ready for the game tonight. Obviously a big playoff game. Can't lose this or you go home. So they're going to be all ready to play, both teams. They're getting ready to line up for the coin toss. The captain's going to come out on the field shortly. Looks like number 15 is going to be the captain again tonight, Rob. Yep.
Jeffrey George Dietrich, senior leader, is going out by himself.
Well, besides being one of our huge leaders, obviously, for the past several years, you know the football team's all very superstitious. And who was the captain against that big win 2 weeks ago?
Captain Jeffrey George Dietrich.
Yes. So you stick with what's working, right?
Here's number one, Derek Irvin. Number five, Jessen Bieniemy.
All right.
Number nine, Tim Maxson. And number 11, Kedrick Richardson. Captains for the Cardinals. Number 15, Jeffrey Dietrich.
It looks like the Cavaliers won the toss. And they have deferred, so the Cardinals are going to get the ball to start the game. So here we go.
We now ask that you stand for the prayer, and please remain standing for the playing of our national anthem, presented by the Edie White Cardinal Vanguard. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Dear Lord, tonight we gather on this field of competition to honor you and to give you thanks for the abundant gifts and talents that you have provided us. We thank you for the ability to participate in sports, especially tonight as we compete in the state playoffs. We thank you for this opportunity and ask that we may use these gifts to the best of our ability to bring honor to you. Help both teams play with respect, fostering good sportsmanship and competition. Provide a safe journey home for all, especially our visitors. All these things we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Thank you.
Let's go!
All right, everybody. It's game time. Edie White's going to receive the ball. De La Salle elected to kick off and put Edie White on offense first.
Got a chance to put our stamp on the game with the big offense. Number 9, Guidry, and number 24, Thompson, back to receive the kick.
T-Ben, this is what we've been ready for all year. Here we go. A short kick.
Yep, short.
Fielded by
up back.
Luke Zerang, number 4.
Nice catch by Luke. Good
Luke's
run.
Still running. Beautiful back. Return.
All the way to the 38, 39-yard line. That's a very good job by Luke.
By Luke.
Yep. Went straight up the field, found a hole, broke some tackles. Look at that, Rob.
Yep.
Good
nice,
replay.
Nice return by Luke. A big thanks to our first quarter sponsor, Athletic Embroidery and Screen Printing of Thibodaux. Give the good folks at Athletic Embroidery and Screen Printing a call. Here come your Cardinals.
Like we've been talking about, the Cavaliers have a good athletic front 7, so we're going to see how our offensive line can handle them. All right, Jake's under center. Keeper by Jake, right behind Carter Douglas. Follows the hole.
About 4 yards there. Let's take a look at our Edie White starting offense, T-Ben. Captained, as always, by Jake Sternfels, senior quarterback. Big Paxton LaFont is also an offensive weapon for Edie White.
Another important senior, yep. All right, here we go. Second down and 6. 4 yards every time is good with me.
Offense looking back for the call.
Give the Carter Douglas this down, only for about a yard gain.
3rd and 5 upcoming for the Cardinals. Let's take a look at De La Salle's starting defense. Led by senior Richardson, linebacker.
De La Salle has 6 seniors starting for the defense, Rob. Good veteran bunch. Big 3rd down play here to start the game.
Pitch out to Rodrigue, nothing doing.
Yep, they had that smelled out.
Well defended by De La Salle for a 4 or 5 yard loss. Here comes your punting unit out.
Yep.
That was a 4th and 10 upcoming. I mean, that's for De La Salle, that's the way you want to start.
Yep, they were ready for that pitch. I mean, he didn't have any chance. They had 4 or 5 guys out there to stop it. So usually the Cardinal offense tweaks itself when the other team's overcompensating. So here it goes. Got a nice little line drive kick. That's going to bounce.
But he's fielding. No, he called fair catch.
Yeah.
Okay.
Still a good punt for high school for sure. Look at that. That's about a 30-yard punt, 35-yard punt.
Good punt by Powell. De La Salle's going to take it, looks like, on the 19-yard line?
No.
No.
Well, maybe so. I don't know. You might be right, Rob. Yep, you're right, Rob. I'm sorry.
Yep, looks like.
So the Cavaliers stop the Cardinals, and they get the ball right away. So we're going to see how this works out. Cardinal defense has to stiffen up here, get the ball back for our big O. De La Salle runs a spread offense like every other school out of the shotgun.
Hand off. Number 4. Big, powerful running back. Nice run by number 4.
By 6 yards.
Yep, lowered his shoulder there.
Yeah, he looks like a load there.
Yep.
Nate Thompson on the tackle there.
Yeah, Nate came up from his safety position. Nice tackle, but 2nd and 4. That's pretty optimal.
Hand off again
to number 4. First down plus.
Yep. They keep sealing off our defensive end and having it wide open there.
Yep.
Same play twice. Same thing happened twice.
First down for De La Salle.
Actually, that time they probably got about 7 yards, so 2 big runs to start the game for a first down. That'll put them at the 32-yard line.
Yeah. 78's doing a good job on the end there, sealing off our defensive end, as you mentioned.
Yes.
4, 5 receivers split out for De La Salle. Puts 1 in motion. Calls for the ball. He wants a pass. Quick pass. Nice. Well defended by, who was that? Thibodaux.
Yep.
Taylor Thibodaux comes in.
Read that play very well. Look, came all the way from the middle linebacker position. That was a quick tackle there.
Zerang did a good job there fighting off his block.
Yes, both of them did well.
Second and 10 upcoming for De La Salle. Arsenault calls for the ball, hands it off to number 6. Looks like he gets about 4 there, huh, Ben?
Yeah.
Nice cutback by number 6. Third and 5 upcoming for the Cavaliers from New Orleans. De La Salle looks big and strong up front on their offensive line, T-Ben.
Yes, they are. They're blocking well.
This is an important
very big play here. They're in the pistol formation this time. Hand off the running back. They got him. Nice job by the Cardinals. Very nice job.
Who was that on that tackle? Is that 2-point Treesh? And 46, Sternfels makes the initial contact.
Yes.
I think
Jax, yep.
I think everybody's going to be happy with that defense. Two defensive stops for both teams to start the game, T-Ben?
Yeah, De La Salle picked up that first down to get a little room here, but you're correct.
Oh, you're right, yep.
We did get him the punt, so that's a big job, good job by the defense.
Guidry and Zerang back for the Cards to return. A little confusion by De La Salle there. Timeout by De La Salle. Oh, I know Coach isn't going to be happy about that. T-Ben, let's take a moment to acknowledge some of our sponsors tonight. Steve Wanko, Wanko Law. Thank you so much, Steve. Bo Grafton and his team at Grafton Dermatology and Cosmetic Surgery. Homa, Thibodaux, Morgan City, and Raceland. Thank you so much. Will Abel, attorney at law. Call Will for personal injury or commercial law. The good people at Blake's Deli out on the bypass road in Thibodaux. If you're in New Orleans listening to this, we have a pretty solid pull boy down here. You take a drive. Comprehensive Hearing Solutions. Thank you so much, Miss Erin Rushing.
All right, they're back on the field after that timeout. I think De La Salle got everything straight now. It's a fair catch by Luke Zerang. Good job there.
Luke is fearless there.
He does. He does a good job of not allowing those extra yards and let it bounce. So that's a good job there.
Let me continue on here, T-Ben. T-Ben, thank you for TBT Contracting, always being a big supporter of E.D. White Athletics. We got a few new sponsors. Jeremy Robichaud, the law office of Jeremy Robichaud. Thank you so much, Jeremy. And we'll catch one more. Popes for Parts. Thibodaux, Schriever.
All right, offense back on the field.
Let's see if E.D. White learned something from that first offensive series, T-Ben. Oh, dangerous! Oh, my God!
Please get up on it.
Please get up on it!
God, dog.
Fumble recovered by De La Salle.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
Oh, the De La Salle defense is reading.
Swarming.
Yes, they're reading the offense good so far. Oh, my goodness.
Yep. A great penetration by De La Salle caused that fumble.
Yep.
And they get the ball in terrific field position.
They stopped the dive cold. They hit the quarterback, and then they had the pitch man as well. They had everything stopped on that play. And then, of course, if he calls the turnover, that's a big, big momentum play there by the Cavalier defense. Let's see if the Cardinal defense can step up here and hold them.
Four receivers split out for the Cavs. Evan calls for the ball, hands it off up the middle. Short gain, two yards, well defended by the Cards.
Much better. They really, really spread you out. Even the offensive line is spread out, Rob, to try to make their running game work, if you'll notice how they do it. Even more than other teams that we've played against.
That's a one-yard gain.
There's going to be a lot of one-on-one tackling that needs to happen to stop the long gains. And we got to maintain the edges as we saw that first drive. So second down and 9 for the Cavaliers.
Calls for the ball. That looked sort of, was it, did he complete it?
They're saying he caught it. All the Cardinals are saying it
bounced off the ground, but the officials is what matters to them, and they said it was a catch.
And so they don't have replay that counts for high school.
Third and 4 or 5 upcoming for the Cavs.
Another play here, but they're going to go for the 4, but this is still a big play, big third down here for the Cardinals.
Arsenault calls for the ball, hands it off to number 4.
There you go. Nice play.
Beautiful good, play by the Cards.
That was nice.
Nice penetration by, who was that, Charlie Dietrich? Let's see. Got back there.
No, it was a linebacker.
Oh, that's Thibodaux again.
Thibodaux right up the
got
middle.
Helped by Charlie.
And then Charlie finished him off. So nice play by the Cardinals. They got to go for it anyway, Rob. Not,
well, I didn't know if they were going to bring their kicking unit out, T-Ben.
Well, you saw him kick off. He. Not that he was horrible, well, but I don't think they're going
to
be kicking long kicks.
I think they
kicks.
Intended to have a short kick like that. Here we go. Here we fourth go. And 5.
This
oh,
is
my
huge.
Goodness.
Big, big play here. I think they bounced.
Arsenault calls for
gotta
the ball.
Got to get some pressure on him. Oh, nice.
Oh, oh, yes! Beautiful play. Beautiful coverage by
32
Thibodaux.
I thought he had it.
Holy mackerel.
That's a big play. Well, good pass.
Out of his hands.
But he did. He knocked it out.
Thibodaux knocked it out. Beautiful play by Thibodaux.
Man, number 17 had that ball and dropped it. Good pass by the quarterback.
Allow me to try to get to some of our other new sponsors. Rocco Dog Productions. Call 1-800-ROCCO-DOG-PRODUCTIONS for all your production needs. Thank you, Glenn Cayouette. Terminex. Homa, Thibodaux. Here we go, Cards.
All right, after that big turnover downs, the Cards take possession at the 21-yard line. Let's see if they can get something rolling here.
Nothing.
Right up the middle.
Yep, well defended.
About 2 yards only.
All right.
Whoo, man, we're going to have to start doing something on offense. You can tell that compared to other teams in our district, this team is well prepared.
Of course, yes. Very athletic defensive front.
But not only that, I'm just talking about for our offense, you got to be disciplined. And practice to stop it. And so far, you can tell they've practiced our defense a lot.
Second and 8.
It's our offense, yeah.
Upcoming. Pitch to.
There you go.
Who's
nice
that? Number 6?
Number 6.
Douglas for the first down.
That was nice. Good job. Now watch. He made him come into him. Two of them came into Sternfels before he pitched it. Nice job there to draw in the offense before he did. Look, two players. That was great. And a good cut by Douglas. Good block. By 40, Tenney,
beautiful.
Yep. That was nice by the Cardinals. Very much needed first down.
T-Ben, that's a Duplantis Design Group first down. Thank you so much, Duplantis Design.
I've never been so happy to see that first down symbol than now. That was very much needed for the Cardinals here.
Hand off to Douay.
Got a good block in there. That was nice.
2 yards for Douay. Let's get through the rest of our first quarter shout-out sponsors. A new sponsor, Amplify Events, T-Ben, and they're having the Sugar Plum Shindig. And it's going to be at the Rendezvous. Check out the Sugar Plum Shindig.
All right, here you go. Carter set up 2nd down and 7. Carter's getting a little bit better push here. Let's see if they can continue that.
Oh,
no.
They, oof, yep, boy, they're that. Swarming.
Yep.
3rd and 7 upcoming for the Cards. 2 more shout-out sponsors. T-Ben, some new sponsors for tonight's game. Trent's Air Conditioning, Homa and Thibodaux. Thank you so much, Trent's AC. Call them for all your AC needs. And, of course, Rouse's, local and family-owned since 1960. Thank you so much for your support, Rouse's.
Is that it, Rob?
Yes.
That's a lot.
Thanks to all of our sponsors, T-Ben.
Yes.
All right, here we go. Jake drops back the pass. Throws it up. LaFond was held.
Oh, he held him.
Oh,
it's such a. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my goodness.
They pulled him.
The refs are keeping the flags in the pocket tonight.
Wait a minute. I don't know if we have it on film. Yeah, we don't.
You see him. 26 pulled him, but no call by the ref, so the punting unit comes out.
4th down and 7.
We'd like to mention to everybody that This is a free broadcast provided to you by Edie White, and the reason it's free is because of our generous sponsors, so you got to bear with us as we acknowledge them. The punt's off.
Very good punt.
Takes a
still a nice punt.
Yeah, Cavalier bounce down to the 30, and they'll come out.
Wonderful job by our kicking specialist, as usual. Going to set up the Cavaliers in their territory at the 30-yard line. So far, we have a little bit of defensive struggle. I'm very proud of the Cardinals for stepping up so far.
They're bending and not breaking, Ben.
Ooh, especially when they got the ball inside the 30-yard line over there, and they didn't get any points. That's awesome.
Coach Kyle's still pretty upset about that. That was, that to us, it looked like clearly a hold.
Yeah.
But anywho, here we go. Arsenault calls for the ball. He wants to pass. Quick pass.
Right in the hole.
Beautiful play to number 80.
Uh-oh. Is number one okay?
Yeah, he's up. Escher pops up. First down.
Number 24, Nate Thompson tackled him, but not until after he made the first down. I was right in the seam there, right in a little open pocket in our zone defense, Rob. And the quarterback hit him right in the numbers, if you saw. That was a good play.
Nice. Three receivers split out for the Cavs.
Nice pop pass there.
Hand off to number four. He gets two or three there.
Yep, I didn't see him tackle him.
I'd like to mention to all of our friends in New Orleans who are tuning in that T-Ben Thompson and myself are not professional broadcasters. We're two dads that took an online course on how to stream and call sports. We did not score well, but our two sons play for Edie White, so please bear with us if we seem overly enthusiastic for the home team.
That was Taylor Thibodaux on the tackle on the last play, Rob.
Quick pass again.
Nice deflection.
Deflected by two-point Treesh.
Yes.
Jumped up there. Third and eight upcoming. Third and seven. Look at Jax.
Look at that vertical leap.
I love it.
Oh. State five foot six, jumping 7 foot 6. Gotta love it.
State champion catcher Jax Treesh out there. Very talented athlete.
Awesome athlete. Yes.
Third and seven upcoming.
Ooh, big play again for the Cardinals defense. Got,
yep. Three receivers split out. Arsenault wants the pass.
Got a lot of time.
By Nate Dog Thompson.
Wow. Nice play by Nate there.
Puts that hand up at the last minute.
Oh, this quarterback can throw. That's a pinpoint pass, Rob. Yeah. Watch this. It's right where it needs to be, but Nate jumps up and knocks it away at the last minute.
Beautifully nice defended play by Nate.
Woo, thank goodness.
So the punt, yes, T-Ben, we got a defensive struggle.
Yeah.
Guidry and Zerang back to receive for the Cardinals.
All right, looks like we put
punts
on the
away.
Return.
Beautiful punt. Fair caught catch signaled by Ben Guidry at the 21-yard line. So, wow, T-Ben.
Lots of defense so far,
Lots
Rob.
Lots of defense.
It's going to be who makes mistakes. It looks like the defenses are dialed in. Of course, we had our mistake, and they didn't capitalize, so that's big. Now the Cardinals could get a few first downs at least, get them back up to their side of the field. It'd be awesome. A lot of times we'll wear on teams when we can keep the ball. We got to start getting some first downs and wear them down. Because, man, they sure dialed in on our offense at the moment.
Big defensive front there for De La Salle.
Yeah. And, again, you can tell how the linebackers are flowing. They practice stopping us all week long. I'm sure they spent many hours to get ready for this game.
Jake calls an audible at the line.
Nice job, Jake.
Cardinals. Jake saw something at the line.
Yes, that worked out great. Oh, he just faked out the defensive linebacker.
Run.
The linebacker read it, was ready, and Jake just faked him out, Rob.
Nice blocking by Paxton LaFont downfield, and that, of course, is a Duplantis Design Group. First down. Thank you so much, Duplantis Design.
Ooh, that was a much-needed play there. Kind of flipped the field here, Rob. Cardinals just need some more confidence. Right up the middle.
Nothing
no gain
doing
at all.
No gain.
Yep. That's some big
it's
balls.
It's
going
to be hard to run in the middle, T-Ben, tonight.
Yeah. Uh-oh, is Carter Douglas limping? No, he's
all right. He's good. He's up.
All right, second down and 10. Look, that's almost the end of the first quarter, Rob. Both teams been running a lot. The clock's been running fast. That was very quick, it seemed.
Quick pitch out to LaFleur. What a big run!
By LaFleur there. Oh, my goodness. Number two here makes an awesome move. Good lead pass. Nice lead by 26. It passing off to the races. Picks up almost 40-something yards
holy
there.
Mackerel.
All the way down to the 20 inside the red zone.
T-Ben, well, first of all, that's another Duplantis design.
First down.
And, of course, now we've entered the Rico Red
We'd
Zone,
like
T-Ben.
To be in the
Rico
Red
Rental
Zone.
And Supply, thank you so much.
All the way down to the 16, Paxton ran that ball. That was gorgeous. Nice play. That's the kind of play you need from your senior, Rob. Carter Douglas again up the middle.
Got two or three there.
Oh, he's touchdown!
Touchdown!
What a play!
Did he get through there? It looked like he was stopped.
I thought I saw him go down. He drove his feet. Let me see
where
this again.
Where is he at? Unbelievable!
Oh, yes! Well, hey, we needed that so bad.
Oh, my gosh, T-Ben. And you know what that means, T-Ben.
Yes.
It's
yes,
a touchdown, guys. Thank you so much, touchdown guy.
Oh, my gosh.
Ty Powell out to kick. Kick is up. And it is good.
Oh, my gosh. What an answer by the Cardinals.
So we also like to recognize our kicking sponsor, Dr. Bo Porsche. Thank you so much, Dr. Bo Porsche of Homa Thibodaux Spine Rehabilitation. He's got your back. Wow. Beautiful drive by the Cardinals.
That was awesome, Rob. All the way down the field, they used some passing with Paxton, our awesome senior wide receiver.
I mean, Jake, Douglas, it looked
magical,
like he was stopped.
Yeah.
Unbelievable
that was great
effort by Douglas.
Yes, yes, yes. It was awesome. Well, all our guys were still blocking. He just got lost in there, Rob. He kept driving his feet, and he just popped out. It was awesome. And look, stop him on a fourth down, almost in our red zone after the turnover. And they come back and score. This is great news for the Cardinals. This is exactly what they needed. Oh, my goodness. That is so awesome.
And you called it earlier, T-Ben. You can't, you know, somebody's going to make a boo-boo. And we scored there. Anyway, again, thanks to everybody who's tuning in from around South Louisiana. We're so proud to be the home broadcast of the E.D. White Cardinals and present this to you for free of charge. We are not professionals, as I indicated earlier. We do our best, and we hope you enjoy. We have great visuals. Here we go. Ty Powell. A little short.
Ooh. Oh.
Oh, like at the one-inch line. That was weird, like a squibby thing.
Yeah,
but so De La Salle's going to get it on the 35-yard line. Looks like Stogie's coming in with some scores, T-Ben. Go ahead and read this one. Thank you so much, Jared Groh, America's top realtor. Turling 7, Madison Prep 7, early in the first quarter, I'm assuming. And they're in our select district.
He also has St. James 7, Northwestern 0, Assumption 8, Brobridge 0. Thank you, Stogie. Appreciate it so much.
Thank you, Jared. Lafayette Christian up 15-0 over Peabody. Arsenault calls for the ball, hands it off to number 4, and he drags Charlie Dietrich for a yard or two. Nice stop by Charlie.
Banks up the middle, gains 2. Tackle number 7, Charlie Dietrich.
Nice play by Charlie defense, number 7, sophomore.
That's the end of the first
quarter,
T-Ben.
Yes. Ooh, it went fast, I find, and Cardinals get to come out of it up 7-0. Again, De La Salle's here to play. They're no joke. Their defense looks very good, and the offense as well. So looks like we're up for a battle tonight. Let's hope the Cardinals are up for the challenge.
You're absolutely right, T-Ben. I'd like to take a moment to thank our second quarter sponsor, Steve Wanko, the Wanko Law Firm. Thank you so much, Steve, for your continued sponsorship of E.D. White Athletics. I'd like to thank all of our sponsors tonight. We're going to do our very best to try to recognize them and give them their due for being terrific sponsors of this broadcast so we can bring it to you free of charge, no subscriptions. And the thing that T-Ben and I like to say is if you're disappointed with with what we're saying, we kindly suggest you turn it on to classic rock or some maybe some Zydeco music or something like that, T-Ben.
Exactly.
But if you could stand to Barris, you know, we'd be happy to keep trying to call the game for you. Three receivers split out for the Cavs. Quick pass.
Trotty! Nice job by Trotty. Put his hands up.
Yes, he sure did. Put his big paw up.
Kept his eyes up. Good block by the defender, but look what he did. Good job.
Yes. Nice hustle by Trotty.
Nice job by Trotty there.
Second and 10 upcoming.
That's exactly how they teach you to do it. If they block it, you just look for the knock it down. That was great. I want to give kudos out to my partner here, Rob Bauer, to be able to do all those sponsors. He does a great job for everybody. Third down and 8, Rob. Big play here.
Arsenault hands it off. Good run.
Goal. That's going to be a first down.
First down. Nice run.
Yeah. Oh, they had him at 3rd and 8, and they did it. A flag, Rob.
Flag on the play, but look, he lowers that shoulder. Oof.
Yeah, that's a big play.
A punishing runner.
They said he's over 200 pounds. They're right at 200 pounds.
Oh, what's the flag? Is it on?
Backing him up. Oh, yeah.
Holding on De La Salle, and then we've got to acknowledge our backup, our penalty sponsor. Yes. Thank you so much, Go Waste. Backing them up, Go Waste, Louisiana's top construction management. Waste management. Thank you, T-Ben.
All right, that's a big call there. Instead of a first down, the Cavaliers are going to be on a 3rd and 18 now. Big play here.
Yeah, that was painful for them.
All right, this is very important. The Cardinals have to hold here.
Four receivers split out. Can't give up the big ball, Ben. Arsenault under some pressure. He gets rid of it.
They're trying to screen pass.
Thibodaux.
What a good read by the defense. Thibodaux with the pressure. But look, if you watch the screen, they try for a screen. Look at him, Rob.
Yep.
And they blew it up. See? The linebacker is all in the way. He had to throw it away. What a good play! Fourth down, but Carter's gonna get the ball back with all the momentum at the moment. Let's hope we keep it. Good job there. All right. Number 9, Guidry, and number 4, Zerang back for the Cardinals. They set up around the right inside the 40-yard line.
Short punt. Wobbly They're gonna punch. Get away from it. Everybody run.
Nope. Oh, good bounce for them, though.
Good field position, though, regardless.
Yes, that is true.
T-Ben, the Pels are up 27-19 over the defending champion Denver Nuggets.
Oh, wow.
The Pels played a great game the other night against the Mavs. They showed a little life after sort of a stagnant start this year.
Yeah.
And Hawkins is shooting lights out from three-point. The Pels desperately need a good three-point shooter.
Everybody still injured, or we got everybody back?
Everybody but Jose is back.
All right. Good. All right, here we go. Cardinals, like you said, set up a good field position here, Rob, at the 45-yard line. Let's see if they can build off that momentum that they got. That was a great offensive drive last time. Big chunk plays came out of that.
Oh, nothing doing. Oof.
Yeah.
Oof.
Sternfeld tried to keep the ball and lost the yard.
Yeah, well defended by De La Salle. Second and 12. Looks like he lost a couple of yards there on that play.
All right, Cardinals set back up for the second and 12 play here.
LaFont split out right. This is the lone receiver. Oof. Again.
Keeps again.
Wow.
This time he gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Yep. So 3rd and 10 upcoming for the Cards. That's not the down and distance the Cards normally are hoping for. Excellent penetration by the Cavs, T-Ben.
So let's see if we go with the Air Cardinals with the shotgun, right? We've been doing all season, Rob. What are you thinking?
Taylor and Guidry come out.
Here comes the wide receivers.
Come out onto the field. Yep.
Yep.
So Jackson Taylor and Ben Guidry. So you got three receivers split out for the Cards.
We're in the shotgun, Rob.
We're in the shotgun. It looks like Tenney's going to help out is with some blocking duties next
so
to.
So the Cardinals are trying to fly, Rob.
Let's go here. Uh-oh.
That's pressure.
Oh.
A little low, but he might have got it. Did he catch that?
The incomplete pass, a little short to Hillman. So
good try.
Nice defensive stand for De La Salle, and the punting unit for Edie White comes out.
Ooh, that was close. I thought Phillip almost got that off the carpet, but I guess it hit the ground. Good try by Phillip, number 18. Here comes the punting unit again. Oh, they're getting close to that, but he got it off. Big booby punt. Off.
Oh, takes a Cavs
bounce.
Takes
a side bounce, yeah. Not too bad.
So they'll take it on the 32-yard line. Of here, let's see, 9:47.
Still a lot of defense, Rob.
This is a battle, T-Ben. I think we knew it. When you get to the playoffs,
I kind of knew
every
that.
Game
I'm
is a battle.
So, I'm just so glad we scored that touchdown. Still, we got a ways to go, but that was a big touchdown. Okay, here we go. First down for De La Salle at the 35-yard line. Same spread out shotgun formation. Hand off right up the middle. Got a little hole. Got a few yards.
Got four yards. Nice hard run there.
Yeah.
By number, is that eight?
Nine, I think.
Number nine. Oh, no, I think that's. Is it nine?
No, you might be right. Might be eight.
Oh, gosh. He got up limping. Hopefully he's okay. That's number eight. He's running off under his own power. He looks good.
That's Kobe Pounds, senior running back. For De La Salle there, Rob.
Picked up
four. You said he's okay?
Yeah. Went no, he ran field. Off under he his own off? Power. Okay. Yeah, that's right. You always want that.
All right, so they bring up second down and six.
Four receivers split out for the Cavs. So we're going to pass here.
Oh, wide open, whoa. But he threw behind him. Ooh, that would have been an easy first down.
Looks
there.
Like he's wiping his hands off on his pants. Maybe the ball was a little wet there. Third and six upcoming for the Cavs.
Pass intended for Jace Bieniemy, another senior wide receiver there. Yeah, like you said, Evan Arsenault, the quarterback there, just a little bit off and behind him. He was open for the first down, and that brings up a big third
down. Big third down. Five receivers split out.
The corner crowd's getting into it, Rob. Yep. You can hear him. He gets some pressure
Arsenault
on.
Drops back. Three. He wants a deep ball. T-Man overthrows a wide open number five. And sort of did the Cardinals a favor there. Overthrew that ball.
Yeah, that was Trish back there covering him.
Now, T-Man, I'm noticing that Arsenault looks like he's a little like he's walking with a little bit of tentativeness in his step. I'm not sure if he
the
injured himself. Yeah, if he injured
oh,
himself
really?
Earlier.
Oh my goodness.
If something's just a little off, maybe I'm not observing correctly, but
okay.
Well, we hope he's okay.
He's okay, yeah.
So Zerang and Guidry back to receive punt number what is this?
Yes,
four, gonna, five.
Oh, we're gonna have lots of punts tonight with the way the defense is
yep.
playing.
I punts you, away.
Oh, that's a high one.
High punt, fair caught. Ooh, caught by Zerang.
Yep. I thought Guidry was going to get
it. Me too. He called for a fair catch, but anywho.
He was trying to fake the defense out of, I guess. The main thing is that, like you, the defense is doing good, and De La Salle's kind of had the Cardinals' number on the option. But when it counted and we had the option, the opportunity, we capitalized. That's big, big time.
Yeah, but we got to have another offensive. We got to
hold the ball. We got to move the ball some. Yeah, I agree. We need some first downs. Need the offensive line to keep up.
Quick
back.
Pass to LaFont. One-on-one. Well defended by number 28 after LaFont gets – how many yards does he get? Four?
That's number 26.
Four-yard gain.
Santana Jolia, another senior, a cornerback.
T-Ben, I'll
for
take
the Cavaliers
it.
First
down and
with the tackle.
4 yards
yeah,
out
we'll
to LaFont.
We'll take 4 yards anytime, but a good tackle, like you said, by the senior cornerback. It seems like the Cavaliers have got lots of seniors playing for them, which is great for their experience. Oh, there you go.
Beautiful run by Sternfels for, what is that, for 4 yards?
Got another 4 yards, yeah.
So third and two upcoming.
Good keeper there by Sternfels.
And tackled by number 11, Pawpaw.
That's the right read there.
Which is the leading tackler for De La Salle, senior. Been playing for a long time. He's got the greatest nickname, Pawpaw. I love it.
Yep, Richardson. Yep, he's a senior.
Third and two upcoming for the Cards. Two receivers split out.
Big time conversion needed here. I know Jake always does a good job making the right reads. Right up the middle. Got it. Douglas again.
He's still running. Beautiful run by nice Douglas. Shot.
Good blocking in the middle of Rob. The hit is just at his ankles. It's a good blocking there with a little hole. And Douglas found a crease. He kept running. Look
kept
at that.
Kept his legs moving.
Yep. Broke a tackle. Got
and
about 8 yards.
That's a first down, T-Man.
Big first down.
Thank you so
all
much, New Planets Design Group.
Yes, first down. Planets Design. Nice. All right. Carter set up shop at the 45-yard line. Clock's running.
Jake rolls out to the right. Quick pass. Wide through, open. Wide open. Guidry. Oh.
That's not Guidry.
No, excuse me. Rodri. Yep. 38. Rodri.
Yes. Good catch and run there. He was wide open. And Jake delivered the ball.
Oh, and Taylor. Right, Jackson Taylor smartly pulled up there. I was worried he was going to block.
Yes,
that guy in the
penalty.
Back, but
yes.
He pulled up. Yes. Another first down. Duplantis Design Group. T-Ben, the Cards are on the move.
Nice design play by the offensive coaches there.
St. James 14, North Webster 0 in the second quarter. Thank you, Jared.
Ooh, Rob Carter's on the move. Another first down. Gotta like it.
Jake keeps the ball.
Oh, they got him that
well time. Defended by number one.
Yep, number one there. Derek Irvin III, another senior.
Yep. For it's a veteran defense.
Cavaliers defense, yep.
He dropped Jake for a two-yard loss.
Look, when you got to have just a week to prepare for this very unorthodox offense, nothing better than have some experienced seniors on your defensive team, huh?
Yes.
You can tell.
Yeah.
I mean, we haven't had a team defend us like this. All year.
Well, Coach, credit to De La Salle coaching staff for getting their team ready.
Yes.
Here we go. Three receivers split out for the Cards. Quick pass to Douglas.
Number five.
Pew!
No, that's Douay.
Excuse me. Douay. My man Douay, number five from down to Bahia. Catches
good
that
catch
ball.
Run. Good takes a nice number 11. Look at the blocking.
Yep.
And he didn't hold either. Again, number 11 with a smart play. Who's number
third in for Jackson Taylor.
Nice job. And Douay with a beautiful run. So that's, yep.
Third and five upcoming for the Cards.
Yep.
An important third down conversion.
We're in their territory now. We're at the 32-yard line. I think we need a little further to try a field goal.
Jake rolls out to the right.
He passes.
Throws it to a wide open LaFont.
Good job.
LaFont makes a nice move.
Play.
Beautiful.
First down. Senior quarterback rolling out. Look at the blocking. That's beautiful blocking.
Beautiful play by the Nichols commit.
Yep.
Paxton LaFont, number two.
Right inside the red zone, Rob.
All right, so guess what? We got a Duplantis Design first down. Thank you so much, Duplantis Design. And we have now entered the Rico Red Zone Rental and Supply. And Thibodaux, thank you so much, Rico.
All right, first down. Deep in the Cavaliers territory here. Handoff to Douglas.
Inside handoff to
ooh, good
Douglas.
Tackle
looks
there.
Like he what, got four?
Ooh,
three
six
or four?
There, a vicious tackle.
No. I'm being generous. Yeah, two. Two
that's
yards.
Number six, Troy Williams.
Oh, what's the flag? What's the late
the
flag here?
There. I don't know.
Uh-oh. What we got going on here? Inadvertent flag?
No,
you
I
picked
think
it
personal
up.
Foul. Looks like y'all are all drawing. Personal foul gets both teams.
Offsetting
teams.
Personal fouls.
Yeah, they would join and push at each other. So that'll nullify the play and they'll redo second down.
JFK 13, Vanderbilt Catholic 0 in the first quarter. T-Ben, that's a tough draw. John F. Kennedy's got a great team this year. Vanderbilt had to drive up to New Orleans to play. So second and 8 upcoming for the Cards in the red zone.
Great opportunity for the Cards to get more points. We're already in field goal range with our awesome kicking team. But you know we want more than that if we can, huh, Rob?
Yes, sir.
Need to take care of the ball here.
Jake's calling an audible, looks
yep.
like to me.
Changes the play.
He sees something.
Yep. Oof. Comfort keeper.
Nothing doing there.
About
number nine on the tackle. Big defensive tackle, number nine.
Yeah, I haven't seen a team play us so technically well on defense, except for that scrimmage in the beginning, that big team.
Zachary.
That's about the only other team that played us this technically well on defense.
Third and 7 upcoming for the Cards, Ben.
Ooh, big play. Come on, guys. Come on. Sternfels gets us out of so many jams. He's been doing so great all season. Got to rely on Jake here.
He's in trouble.
Knock it down.
Oh, that was so dangerous.
Oh, we need these 3 points.
Well, I know Jake didn't want to take the sack.
But he should have took the sack. But it doesn't matter. It worked out.
Right.
Ooh, that was just in the air forever. I was like counting the seconds.
Yes.
Ooh, that was big time.
Right, Edie White dodged a bullet there.
Yes, because we got a great kicking team. I don't want to jinx him or anything, but he's been great all season, his whole career.
All right, I'm knocking on your head.
Yes, lots of wood in there.
What is the there's a little confusion there. We still got a little time to get out there. Onkow comes out. How many yards here, Ben?
34.
Kick is up, and it is
long enough for sure.
Good! Yes! Beautiful. Todd Powell with the 35-yard kick.
Big 3 points there.
Thank you so much, Dr. Bo Borsch. He's got your back. See, Ben, I'm going to take a moment to try to run through some of our.
I'll tell you what, I love Todd Powell. He's
Todd Powell
awesome.
Is awesome. Thank you so much, Dr. Bo Grafton of Grafton Dermatology. Will Abel, attorney at law. Call Will for all your personal injury or commercial needs. Delicious Blake's Deli out on the Thibodaux Bypass Road. Aaron Rushing at Comprehensive Hearing Solutions, thank you so much. TBT Contracting, thank you so much, T-Ben, for all your sponsorship. A new sponsor, Jeremy Robichaux. Jeremy P. Robichaux, Law Offices. Popes for Parts in Thibodaux and Schriever for all your auto and truck parts. Rocco Dog Productions. Call 1-800-ROCCO-DOG for all your production needs. Thank you so much, Glenn Rocco Caluet. Terminex of Homa and Thibodaux. Thank you so much, Terminex. And here goes Ty Powell.
Big kick out the end zone this time.
Out the end zone.
That was a nice kick.
T-Ben, I got a few more sponsors. A new sponsor, the good people at Amplify Events. They have a Sugar Plum Shindig. Sponsored by Green Acres Christmas Store. The Shindig's going to be at the Rendezvous. Put that back up again. It's on the 9th and 10th. It's a two-day event, T-Ben. You can take the kids out there.
Sounds
Have
fun.
Have a great time. Thank you so much, Amplify Events. Trent's Air Conditioning for all your AC needs. And, of course, Rouse's. Local and family-owned since 1960. And started right here in Thibodaux, Louisiana. T-Ben, thank you so much, Rouse family.
All right. Cavaliers start at the 20.
Arsenault pitches out. He puts it on the carpet, but he gets it. Bounces right in his hand, T-Ben. Right. A lucky pounce.
Yeah, number four, Jason Banks there with the carry. Ball went right back in his hands.
Wow.
Very fortunate.
Yes.
That would have been a big
fortuitous.
Play.
Fortuitous.
Yes, that would have been a big play there. Now he gained 6 yards on the play, too.
So yeah.
So that's not too good. So I'm bringing that up second and six.
4:55. Yeah. Nobody can see that, but I just like to repeat myself.
Oh, the corner defense has been doing so good. I don't want to jinx him, but gracious.
All right, knock on your head again. Here we go. Hand off to number four up the middle. First down. Beautiful run by number four.
Number four, Banks again, the senior running back.
Let's take a look at it. A physical running back up the middle, and it takes a couple guys to bring him down. Beautiful run by number four. Yeah,
first down at the 34.
Thank you so much to our second quarter sponsor, Steve Wanko, the Wanko Law Firm. Three receivers split out for the Cavaliers. Arsenault, high snap, gets it off to four.
This time,
he broke a tackle. Joe Thompson! Golly, Nate Thompson's like a rocket. Comes in from nowhere.
Now forward, a big stiff arm here.
Now, Jack slowed him down a smidge.
Yep.
Wow, with that stiff arm, but here comes Nate Dogg. Boom!
Ooh, that's a big bar number
four.
Wow! Woo!
Nice, rough, physical, hard-running running back there, but Nate comes up and gives a lick. It's second and 10.
I'm glad he got it down, because if we'd have bounced off and kept running, that would be pretty embarrassing. But a good job on my son there.
Your son did a good job.
He bounced off him a little further than he did, but he got it down. So that's all that counts. All right, no gain there, Rob. So that's second down and 10. Big play by the Cardinal defense.
Arsenault wants to pass.
Oh, going deep again. No! He's got to
Arsenal wants to run.
Yeah. He usually doesn't run, but he
sure
got a few yards.
So he wasn't happy about something and decided to take it down and run.
Yeah, good coverage downfield. Nobody was open. Look, he had time.
Yep. Charlie defense has got to come out. Arsenal did pick up 2 or 3 yards.
And 43 flushed him out of the pocket there.
Noah Benoit.
So nice job.
Charlie's got to come out because his helmet came off. So Cooper Passman, number 14, junior, defensive tackle, comes in. Third and 7, very important down here.
Big play. Again, the Cardinal crowd comes alive, Rob. Kind of makes some noise for the defense.
Arsenal.
He needs some pressure. He's got some time. Wide open for the
beautiful
first down.
Oh,
number 14 make with a tackle. Reception there.
First down for the Cavaliers.
Number
beautiful
14,
pass.
Number 14, Haynes, another senior wide receiver with the catch there, Rob.
Right, went in the soft part of the zone there.
Yep. 33, Thibodaux.
And first down, and the Cavaliers keep things alive here with a few minutes left to go in the first half.
They're almost in our territory, Rob. They're right at the 50-yard line.
I think they're going to pass some more
Let's
here.
See
Let's see here.
Oh,
a quick pitch out to number 4.
Good blocking,
oh,
man.
Well defended by the Cardinals.
Yes, a lot of gang tackling there.
A flock of Cardinals on the tackle, T-Ben.
Yes, look, I thought he had it. Then all of a sudden, very fast.
Boom, Thibodaux.
That's Thibodaux again. Boy, Thibodaux is quick to the ball. And did everybody finish him off? Luke, et cetera. Like you said, a flock of Cardinals there to hold him to a short gain of about 1 yard.
Yep, second and you got a couple of yards.
Yeah.
Second and 8 upcoming for De La Salle.
Clock is running almost within 2 minutes here. The Cardinals got to stop this drive. Big second down and long. They really do even it out to pass and run.
All right, Arsenal wants to pass
going
again.
Deep.
He's going for the deep ball. He's got a wide open 17. But he got the ball. Get the ball.
No, no, it's out. It's incomplete.
Oh, out of the end zone. Is it incomplete? Is it incomplete? Is it not? But then he fumbled it out of the end zone.
He didn't have it.
He fumbled it out of the end zone.
I love it. That's not what I would call it. That's an incomplete pass. But I love it.
So they
we get the ball.
Right. Okay.
At the 20. That's a huge play. Wow.
Oh, man.
I would have called that incomplete. There's no way he
I mean, that is a Cardinal break there. If there's any Cardinal breaks.
Well, we had a couple of hit guards.
Wow.
That was good.
Reception.
Good play. Was at 32. Was that Thibodaux? No.
Thibodaux stripped the ball,
right.
And the ball
went out the back of the end zone.
Out of
so
the
we get
back of the end zone, and we get it.
Because
awesome.
They called it a completion. But that's – anyway, it doesn't matter. Awesome play by Thibodaux to catch back up. Goodness, he was wide open, Rob. Wow.
Yes.
What a good play.
Yes,
what a good
that
hustle
was a
play. That's a hustle play.
You know what, T-Ben? We got 145. Can the Cardinals get some points on the board?
That'd be great, but I just want to run the clock out. This has been a defensive struggle.
I want points, T-Ben.
Well, yes. Well, with the way this game's going, I'm nervous. But, yeah, if we get points, I'd love it. Just don't give the ball back. Run your offense and run the clock.
Lucky
if
break
we,
for the
we
Cards there. Here
runs.
We go. Pitch out to Rodri. Come on, Rodri.
Yeah.
Out of bounds.
Don't go out of bounds.
Oh, flag on the play, Ben. That might be a late hit or a horse collar.
Another 15 yards. Would be
Let's
great.
See what's going on here. What's the penalty, Ben?
I don't know yet. It looks like it's on them, though.
They're marking it off. Well?
Yeah, it's against them. Must be a
15 yards.
Late hit. Must be a late hit.
Late hit. Oof. Yeah. So that's good for the Cards, bad for De La Salle.
Yeah, now we're getting a little bit to where maybe we go for some points here.
Our friends with the Bandads have delivered again.
Oh, my goodness.
Thank you so much, Corey Poinbuff.
We forgot. Hey, Corey, how are you?
Father of champion swimmer, Cade Poinbuff.
Yes. We forgot to tell him we didn't have as many people. We're going to
have my goodness. Here we go, T-Men. We're talking food.
Oh, no. Tackle. Loss. Tackle for a loss.
Tackle for a loss. The clock is running. I'm sorry, everybody. We got sidetracked with food that our friends bring in.
Now they're learning we get lots of condiments. We got ketchup, mayonnaise,
Thank you so much, Corey.
Really appreciate the Bandads.
Nice.
Thanks, Corey.
Nice stop by De La Salle. 120 and ticking. I'm not sure what.
All right, we got to start worrying about our food. Yes, that was
I'm
a big, bad play there. Loss of 5 yards there for the Cardinals.
I think it's our fault.
But the clock's running. That's good. Again, I'm not. If we could get points, that's great, but as long as we don't give the ball back.
Jake rolls out.
Lots of pressure there. Ooh. Did he catch that?
Did he catch it?
Yes, they gave it to him.
Unbelievable catch by LaFleur.
Was he even throwing it to him? I thought he was throwing it to heads up play by Paxton. I thought he was throwing to Guidry.
Well, the clock is still going here, Ben.
Yeah, the clock's running.
Pitch out to Guidry.
Get out of bounds now. Now you get out of bounds. Points because we got that awesome field goal.
Why isn't the clock stopping?
Wait, that was out of bounds.
Okay. They ran out of bounds.
That's supposed to be a home clock. What's up with that? We just lost 6 freaking seconds.
Okay.
Who is that?
I'm not sure. Okay.
Well, we know. We need to go.
All right. Shh.
Anyway, that was a pass to Guidry, I think. And Paxton caught it? Is that what you saw?
Yeah.
That was great.
That was incredible.
Paxton with the awesome hands right off the turf.
Oh, man.
That was great. All right. First down.
Well, timeout. Oh, my gosh, I haven't been doing our – of course, we made a first down. Thank you so much, Duplantis Design Group. I think they're telling them – yes, they added time back onto the clocks.
Yes, they did. Good job. So that was for no gain. They went out of bounds. So the second down at 10, the clock stops. We got some time back. It's 50 seconds left. And again,
I mean, I know Kyle's at least thinking to try to get into
field goal range. Oh, yeah. Well, now that you cross the midfield, yes, you switch your whole line of thinking.
Well, I'd like to point out now you're changing your tune.
Pass midfield.
What?
Look, there was a game back a little while ago where we did all this food assistance and we gave up 14 points in 17 seconds.
Here we go. Oh, no. Oh, my God, T-Ben.
Now
did we get the ball back? I will not tease you anymore.
Yeah, they got the ball.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, that was such bad timing of my joke. Fumble.
Stop him. Oh, my gosh.
Recovered by De La Salle with 42 seconds left.
So much momentum is going to go down the drain if this happens.
No, we're going to get a stop, Ben. Positivity.
I missed the play because I was watching the screen instead of live. Did you see what happened? It was a sack, strip sack?
Yeah.
Strip sack of our quarterback.
Nice play by the defense for De La Salle.
Yeah, that's a big play by them. Let's see what happens here.
Try deep balls.
I guess, 40 seconds. I mean, 45 seconds. The clock stops every first down. They could go for some first downs and get it close. Or go for deep balls, either one. They have 2 timeouts left, Rob. So they can run the ball, too, if they want to. They won't, though. They'll pass it wide open.
Hits number 5 in the hands, and he drops it.
Number 5, Bieniemy again, the senior wide receiver.
I think 3 seconds ran off the clock, so 41 seconds left. Plenty of time.
Second down at 10.
Second and 10, number 41.
Oh, if the Carter defense could step up again after turn, it would be amazing.
Oh,
please, guys. They've been so great all night.
Here we go.
Oof.
Arsenal calls for the ball. Hands off up the middle.
Oh, no.
Goodness. He's gone.
No, he's not. Oh, yes, he is. Oh, he broke both tackles.
Yeah, beautiful run by number 4 for a touchdown.
That's a disaster.
Wow. Hard run right up the middle.
Now, why did he try to strip him? Just tackle him. You can tackle him right here. Boy, that's a big boy, though. Number 4.
Number 4 with a hard run for a touchdown.
That's Jason Banks, senior running back, Rob.
Yep, beautiful run by number 4 right before the end of the half.
The defense did so well, and then we turn over. That's all right. The boys been playing good. It's going to be a tough battle now in the second half, Rob.
Well, we knew we were in for a game. Ben, timeout. There appears to be some confusion.
Boy, 10-0 going in the half as opposed to 10-7. Big difference. But.
Well, no point of crying over spilt milk, Ben.
You're right. Stiff upper lip, as the British say. We've got to get moving. What happened, Rob? They hit the wrong kicking people out there?
I think, there's some.
So De La Salle called a timeout?
I do believe De La Salle called a timeout to get their kicking unit straightened out.
Yeah.
So they'll be out to, I believe, try for the extra point, unless they're going to try to go for 2 here. I can't imagine they'd do that. But
I wouldn't think so, unless the kicker is horrible. And he didn't seem that bad. I would think they would just go.
Here we go. Kick is up, and it looks good. So with 34 seconds left in the first half, De La Salle strikes back and cuts the margin to 10-7.
All right. Well, that's a big blow to the Cardinals, but they've been playing good all half. That was a short field after the turnover. The Cavaliers have a quick 40-yard drive right at the end of the first half to score their first touchdown to bring the score to 10-7 and make the deficit a little closer than it was before. So Cardinals will receive the kickoff here. Number 24, Thompson, and number 9, Guidry, back to receive the kickoff. We'd like to give a quick shout-out to our wonderful friends that just had surgery there. The Pritchards, Tyler Pritchard, Nate's friend, he's a junior for the Edie White football team, had ACL surgery recently, and he's laid up watching his Cardinals on our streaming broadcast here. And we want to give him a quick shout-out and wish him a quick recovery and hope his pain subsides soon. And we're all thinking about you there, Tyler.
Get well, Tyler. All right, here we go. De La Salle out to kick. Short
kick. Big high kick again.
Fielded by Zerang. Zerang! With a nice return.
All right. How about this? How about we kneel it 3 times? That'd be nice.
Evangel T-Ben, 13, Shaw 10 in the second quarter. What a battle that is. That's two great teams
right
there.
A big score for us, Rob. Turling's 14, Madison Prep 14.
Yeah, T-Ben, there's some incredible games in the Select Division 2 tonight.
Yeah. Assumption 8, Brobridge 8, tied at 8.
Assumption's been playing so great. St. Thomas More looks like they're way on top of Estruma, 27-0 in the – it's got to be the second, I would think, by now.
Thanks for the scoring update, guys.
Thanks, everybody. I tell you what, De La Salle, no quitting them.
It's a very good game. They're a very good team. I feel so drained right now because I was so happy at how awesome the defense was doing, and then that happens. It's just, oh my goodness. That's okay. We got to bounce back. I mean, I don't know what you do right here. We do have good field position, Connor, but I think you just run it up the middle 3 times and get it over
and
with.
Take it in for half. But
that's just me, but we'll see.
Well, I'm not saying anything anymore after I jinxed this.
I mean, it's been a defensive game, so you don't want to give him the ball with a short field.
Sternfels is going to run.
Yep.
Nothing doing. Well defended.
Yeah, they don't have any timeouts either, so that's it. All right. That'll be in the first half. Edie White 10, Cavaliers 7. So we're going in half with a close game here, Rob.
Well, T-Ben, wow, a defensive battle in the first half, and we're going to be in for quite a finish here in the second half. I'm not really quite sure what Edie White has planned for halftime. I see the dance squad coming out. I do not believe the band is going to perform tonight, so we'll let you take in the Edie White dance squad and any other activities that happen to be happening. So thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, for your halftime entertainment, the De La Salle High School Cavalettes will perform a routine.
knew I said goodbye. Hands in the air, let's just apply. Thank God that I'm alive. I've been popping all my life. This way I go every night. I've been popping all my life. Thank God that I'm alive.
Oh, thank the Lord I'm alive. Yes, we not feeling your vibe. Yeah. Play it out in time.
Great job, ladies. To continue your halftime entertainment, we welcome the Edie White Cardinalette Dance Team. Under the leadership of Captain Mackenzie Steinman and co-captain Addison Calabro, the Cardinalettes will perform a palm routine to conga. Good luck, ladies. Your music is on. At this time, we wish to congratulate our fall performing groups and sports teams. First, the Edie White Cardinal Vanguard, who completed its marching season at the Louisiana Showcase of Marching Band State Championship. Under the direction of Ms. Lana Degg, Mr. Brad Adams, Mr. Quinn Morrow, Mr. Keith Leday, and Mr. Jeremy LeBlanc, and Ms. Olivia Adamitz. The Cardinal Vanguard placed first in its class, first in drum major, first in percussion, first in guard. It was the only band in its class to be named to the top 10. They were eighth overall of 34 bands. Congratulations, Cardinal Vanguard. The Lady Cardinal volleyball team, coached by Coach Sarah Johnson, Emily Bourgeois, and Samantha Ordon, captured the district championship and advanced through the state tournament and earned the state runner-up title for Division III. Congratulations, Lady Cardinal volleyball team. The Edie White cross country team, under the direction of Coach Jordan Reed, the girls captured the regional championship, had three runners in the top 10 at the state cross country meet, and were named state runner up in their division. The boys captured the regional runner up title and placed fifth at state. Congratulations, Cardinal Cross Country. The Edie White swim team, under the leadership of Coach Andrea Lotz, captured the district championship, the metro championship, and the boys and girls yesterday once again captured the state championship. Congratulations, swimmers. And the Edie White football team, currently ranked 2 in the state, had an undefeated regular season, captured the district championship, and is hosting the regional playoff game under the direction of Coach Kyle Lesang and his coaching staff. Congratulations, Cardinals. And we wish good luck to our winter sports teams, boys and girls basketball, boys and girls soccer, as they begin their seasons. We look forward to great seasons.
All right, everybody, we'll go ahead and recognize our season-long presenting sponsor.
At Thibodaux Regional Wellness Center, we're improving the health and well-being of the region one person at a time. And this means more game time, more first times, more crunch time, more face time, and more party time. Isn't it time you started living your best life? Change starts here at Thibodaux Regional Wellness Center.
Thank you so much, Thibodaux Regional, for your season-long presenting sponsorship. We'll go ahead and also recognize our season-long streaming sponsor.
For 17 years, the Center for Pediatric Therapy has proudly been the Bayou region's only dedicated pediatric therapy clinic to offer all three major therapy disciplines. We provide pediatric speech, occupational, and physical therapy, and have a combined 135 years of pediatric therapy experience. Additionally, many of our speech and occupational therapists are cross-trained to offer feeding therapy. All of these services are provided in our spacious, company-owned facilities in both Houma and Thibodaux, in approved school settings or in homes of children age 0 to 3 who are enrolled in the Early Steps program. If you feel like your child could benefit from any or all of our services, please call our friendly front office staff and they would be happy to answer all of your questions.
Thank you so much, CPT, for your years of sponsorship of Edie White Athletics. We're still a few minutes away from the start of the second half, and we'd like to go ahead and feature a little video that we made regarding Edie White's commitment to health and safety for its football players.
Yeah, I think the idea of the Guardian Cap is part of our total injury prevention program, along with our trainers. You know, we've always tried to do the best that we possibly can to avoid injuries, all injuries, ACLs, and concussions was one of those injuries that I think we can prevent or try to prevent as much as possible. And so it was really kind of a three-tier program to try to avoid those kinds of injuries, because those injuries can linger, those injuries can be extended period of time, and we wanted our wanted our athletes back on the field as quickly as possible. So first thing we did was change the way we practice, maybe decrease the amount of contact that you're going to have during the week. Second thing was to improve the turf, and that obviously was something that we did. But the third prong of the protocol was try to get guardian caps for every single one of our athletes, and that happened based on some generous donations from people that really are interested in the program and our kids. So I think all three of those things together have shown tremendous results in the decrease in number of concussions that we've seen over the years. So you know, those injuries that might have happened because of a head-to-head contact or a head bouncing off of a turf or something like that, we've seen a dramatic decrease in those injuries. So I'm very grateful that we can have every kid with a guardian cap on. The kids have really, really taken to it. I think they see the importance of it and they want to be on the field as well. So it's been tremendous for us, and hopefully we'll continue this as the program moves on. We're also able to put these on our eighth graders. So it's something that we hope is going to last a long, long time in our program and really help in injury prevention.
All right, a big thanks to all those terrific supporters of Edie White Athletics. We're a few minutes away from play resuming, so we'll go ahead and reintroduce you to the Edie White 2023 starting, or the Edie White roster of players, of football team. Thank you so much.
Noah Benoit, D-line.
Nye Buttery, quarterback. Joshua Courtright, wide receiver.
Jeffrey Dietrich, running back.
Andrew Douay, running back.
Matthew Escher, weak safety.
Paxton LaFont, wide receiver.
Evan Lejeune, linebacker.
Jensen Malasson, cornerback.
Jacob Onko, offensive tackle.
Landon Pornbuff, running back.
Foster Porsche, offensive line.
Cohen Stagney, D-line.
Jake Sternfels, quarterback.
Jackson Taylor, wide receiver.
Michael Tenney, running back.
Taylor Thibodaux, linebacker.
Ty Thibodaux, cornerback.
Michael Beck, O-line.
Ben Blanchard, O-line.
Hugs Blanchard, O-line.
Tommy Bauer, offensive line.
Matthew Broussard, linebacker.
Jake Carrier, O-line.
Ben Guidry, quarterback.
Zach Gillen, O-line.
Bryce Hawley, safety.
Jackson Abear, cornerback.
Phillip Hillman, tight end.
Governor Mauer, weak safety.
Hudson Allcow, O-line.
Grant Page, defensive end.
Cooper Passman, defensive tackle.
Ty Powell, specialist.
Tyler Pritchard, linebacker.
Max Richard, D-line.
Dylan Robichaud, strong safety.
Benjamin Rodrag, running back.
Thomas Rosado, defensive tackle.
Aiden Saunier, wide receiver.
MJ Sternfels, linebacker.
Adam Talbot, defensive tackle.
Nate Thompson, free safety.
Jax Trish, strong safety.
Luke Trotty, defensive end.
Evan Weber, cornerback.
Luke Zerain, cornerback.
Seth Andrus, defensive tackle.
Cooper Andrews, offensive line.
Glenn Narby, defensive end.
Evan Arsenault, cornerback.
Landon Babin, cornerback.
Trey Babin, right tackle.
Grant Barbera, quarterback.
Cole Bodian, wide receiver.
Marcel Benoit, safety.
Chris Bourgeois, safety.
Luke Cortez, defensive tackle.
Matt Cortez, O-line.
Charlie Dietrich, defensive end.
Carter Douglas, running back.
Alden Fields, linebacker.
Parker Hemel, cornerback.
Harrison Jones, D-line.
Jonathan Lee, linebacker.
Carter Myers, safety.
Chase Knockan, wide receiver.
Joseph Pisciola, right guard.
Owen Porsche, cornerback.
Jackson Richet, free safety.
Philip Roop, offensive line.
Hudson Simino, O-line.
Hayes Tabor, tight end.
All right, everybody, they added a few more minutes onto the clock, so a couple of minutes left before the kickoff start in the second half. De La Salle is going to get the ball, and we're certainly in for an exciting second half of football. So everybody stand by, and we'll be back shortly. All right, we'll go ahead and take a moment to acknowledge all of our awesome shout-out sponsors. Thank you so much to Dr. Bo Grafton and his team at Grafton Dermatology and Cosmetic Surgery in Houma, Thibodaux, Morgan City, and Raceland. Will Abel, attorney at law, personal injury and commercial, call Will Abel. Blake's Deli out on the bypass road, delicious breakfast, lunch, and dinner at the good people at Blake's. Miss Erin Rushing at Comprehensive Hearing Solutions in Houma and Thibodaux. Thank you so much, Erin. TBT Contracting for all your general contracting commercial needs. Attorney at Law, Jeremy P. Robichaud. Call the law offices of Jeremy P. Robichaud. We're so fortunate to have three great attorneys sponsoring our broadcast. You can't go wrong with any of those guys. Popes for Parts, Auto Parts. In Thibodaux, Schriever, call the good people for your truck and auto parts. Rocco Dog Productions, call 1-800-ROCCO-DOG for all your production needs. Thank you so much, Glenn Caillouette. Terminex in Houma and Thibodaux. And we'll get our few other folks in after this kickoff, T-Ben. Ty Powell out to kick for the Cards.
Yep, here we go. Second half action.
Oh, fielded by number 35. He's going to return it. Gets it down to the 22. Nice return by number 35. So your EDY defense comes out. And your De La Salle offense. Let's go ahead and pull up the starters for De La Salle. Evan Arsenault, quarterback, junior.
By the way, that tackle was by Governor Maurer there.
Nice good, play good tackle by Governor. Oops. We'll acknowledge your defensive starters for the Cards after this play.
All right. Here we go. Start the second half.
Shotgun pitches it out on the short side.
Good tackle there.
Well defended.
You want to set the tone here, Rob, right at the beginning of the second half.
No gain there. We'll see who's this on this stop here, Ben. That's Trotty.
Good tackle.
Trotty, who else helps? I think that's Thibodaux. Let's acknowledge our defensive starters, T-Ben. No gain on the play.
Second and 10.
Again, after that late score that kind of switched the momentum, it's very important that the Cardinals come out here and set the tone again. And enrich that momentum back, Rob.
He's going to hands off to number 4 again.
Wow.
Beautiful play by 33. Thibodaux
with a big
excellent
hit.
Excellent penetration.
Shoots the gap. Look at this. Boom.
Nice tackle.
Now, look, of course, that big running back bounced off, but it doesn't matter. That was still strong. A nice hit. And then the rest of the Cardinals cleaned it up. That's the way you set the tone.
Well,
this is big, Rob. 3rd and 12. You got to get off the field here. Cardinals need to get the ball back. Big, 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 big play.
The crowd's coming alive. Our secondary needs to be ready. Four receivers split out.
They're going
to
pass here.
Let's see if we can get some pressure on him. No pressure. He's got all day long. Wide
open up the middle.
14. Tackled by Nate Thompson, but a long gain.
Yeah, big play
for De La Salle. Nice pitch and catch.
Number 14, Brad Hayes, senior wide receiver with the big catch there. That's a 30-40-yard gain.
Yep.
Two of the Cardinal defenders covered one player, and the middle of the field was left wide open. Big busted play by the Cardinal defense. The Cavaliers now set up in Cardinal territory at the 30, 7-yard line here. That's a disappointing. That was third and long, right?
Yep. And they converted. Three receivers split out for De La Salle. Arsenault calls for the ball, hands it off to big number four.
Again, bust the middle.
There
again,
he goes.
Again, Brugget tackles.
Yep, good run by number four.
That's the first down. Yep, over 10 yards. First down, easy play there. All right, here you go. Let's see if the Cardinals can stiffen up. This is a big drive. If they can come out and score again, that'd be back-to-back at the end of the half and the beginning of the half. They would have all the momentum. Big, big gut check for the Cardinals at the 22-yard line now. First down for De La Salle.
Fakes the pitch. Wide
open.
Wide open, number 80. Touchdown for De La Salle.
That's a well-designed play.
Sure is.
Goodness.
Your linebackers and your cornerbacks bit on the pitch, and that was it.
Yep. Goodness.
De La Salle has taken the lead with 9:19 left in the third quarter.
Wow. So after a full quarter and all the way up to under a minute left in the first half, the Cardinals even shut them out. And now within a span of 3 minutes, they give up two big touchdowns.
Kick is up, and it looks good. So De La Salle on top. 14-10.
And they have all the momentum.
Let's see how our offense can answer that, Ben.
Yep.
All right. Go ahead and get our other sponsors in. Sugar Plum Shindig by Amplify Events, December 9th and 10th at the Rendezvous. Visit their Facebook page to learn more. Trent's Heating and Air Conditioning. Thank you so much, Trent's. Give them a call for all your heating and air conditioning needs. And, of course, Rouse's, local and family-owned since 1960. Thank you so much, Rouse's. Oh, and, of course, we want to acknowledge our third quarter sponsor, Claymaw Family Dentistry. Thank you so much, Claymaw Family Dentistry.
Hey, Rob, do you remember in the 80s, I think it was the 80s, they had that commercial with the guy with the little mighty machines and he would talk real fast? That's what you need to do to get all those commercials.
Oh, like sweet.
I don't remember the mighty machines.
I just speed up myself.
Yeah, speed like super quick.
All right, D-Ben, this is an incredibly important offensive possession for the Cards.
Yeah. I do think
he kicks it deep, and it's going to be the return is on by, I'm not sure who that is. Whoa!
Who is that? 89,
that's Chase Knockhair.
Yes.
Very nice, Chase Knockhair, sophomore.
Beautiful play
with the
there.
Speed. What's the change here?
Nice play by Chase.
What, nice vision by Chase.
Yes. Good blocking, too.
And, dude, that's exactly what Edie White needed, T-Ben. Chase gets it to midfield, nearly midfield. Beautiful play by the sophomore. Son of Slick Rick Knockhair and Christy Zarang. Edie White, two receivers split out to the right. I know that's LaFont. I think that might be Douay, number five.
Keeper by
Jake keeps the ball. Beautiful hard run by Jake. He gets 6 yards, Ben.
Yep, got 6 yards and first down.
Spinning run. Look at that. Nice run by Jake. Second and three upcoming for the Cards. Jake keeps it again. Not much doing there. I think he tackled, maybe gets back to the original line of scrimmage. So third, no, he lost a yard. Third and four upcoming for the Cards.
Got some quick updated scores here. We got JFK 26, Vanderbilt 6 at halftime. St. Michael 21, Livingston 8 at halftime, and Lutcher 21, Abbeville 6 at the start of the third quarter.
All right, Ben. Two receivers split out to the right. Quick pass. Oh,
well, no. He did not catch that. Are they calling that a catch? They are. They're going to give him a touchdown. He did not have a possession for more than 3 seconds. Well, I guess high school's different than college and pros. Anyway, that's a big play for the Cavaliers. That's a touchdown.
Quick touchdown for the Cavaliers off the strip fumble. Number one.
Well, I guess if they called the play the first half, it wasn't a catch. They did the same in here. They're consistent. Can't argue with that.
Yep. Nice nice play by the defense. Quick touchdown.
That is huge.
That is huge.
Goodness gracious. What a turn of events here. And a change in momentum. Oh, my gosh.
De La Salle out to attempt the extra point. Kick is up. Oh, and it's blocked. All right. Is that Thibodaux? Got his hands on it? Nice block.
Not sure.
Keeps the margin to 10 points, T-Ben.
Yeah, Thibodaux. Nice play by Thibodaux. So the score is 20-10. Cavaliers on top of the Cardinals. With 7 minutes 55 left in the third quarter.
Well, T-Ben, Edie White is in an unfamiliar position this season. Trailing by 10 points in the third quarter. We've had a couple of uncharacteristic turnovers, but all credit due to the Cavs. They stripped that ball and took it all the way to the house. All right, here we go. De La Salle. Oh, a little pooch thing. Fielded by Jonathan Lee. Jonathan Lee gets another 5 yards. Edie White gets the ball up at the 37-yard line.
Yeah, good field position there. Good job by Jonathan. All right, Cardinals need to bounce back here. Need to show some life here. Got a first down. Good field position. Time to move that ball. Jake's been leading us all year long. I'm sure he could come back again. And spark the Cardinals, our senior quarterback here, lining up under center. Hillman in motion.
Edie White resets. Jake looks back for the play. Hand off to, I'm not sure who that is, but tackled for a 2-yard loss, it looks like.
Yeah, the De La Salle defense is fired up now.
They sure are.
Getting a lot of penetration. That was Rodri on the carry there, Rob. That'll bring up a second and long.
Well, T-Ben, we knew De La Salle was a tough opponent at the 15 seed. They're not really 15 seed team. Excellent team. Uh-oh, injury timeout for De La Salle. Hope that player's okay.
Yeah, tough draw by the Cardinals to get such a good team, well-coached team, athletic team. It's the perfect team to give our offense trouble because they're definitely on sync on how to read the plays and stop our offense so far, and they're so athletic and strong. So tough draw. When you lose momentum too, we still got a lot of young players, a lot of juniors and some sophomores playing too. So we've never faced this kind of adversity really all season. So big gut check time for the Cardinals.
Second and 11 upcoming for the Cards. And they have done an excellent job. The Cavaliers have, T-Ben, shutting our run down tonight. LaFont split out to the right, one-on-one with the cornerback. Pass to LaFont. Where's the flag? There's a flag. Interfered with. That's going to be first down. They drag LaFont to the ground.
Yeah, they call it that time.
Yep.
It's almost the same thing he did last time. Right. I would keep doing it, too, if they don't call it.
Yeah.
So good 15-yard penalty gives the Cardinals a first down. Updated score, Assumption 15, Brobridge 8.
So, wow.
Man, Assumption might make pass the second round, right?
Yeah, that'd Assumption's be pretty awesome. Assumption's been playing great football at the end of the season, Ben.
Yeah.
So, 15-yard penalty, much needed, and that is a – oh, I forgot. My penalty. Thank you so much.
Well, that's back up.
Go forward. Waste. Well, that's a push them forward penalty. Thank you so much, Go Waste.
You design the plan's design group is what you should be doing. It's the first down.
Well, T Ben, thank you for reminding me. You're always keeping me on my toes. Oh, here we go, Jake. My gosh, dangerous pitch to Rodrigue, but Rodrigue gets whatever 3 yards.
Yeah. Man, they're so fast. Usually, all the rest of the season, that'd have been a big run, but that's some fast response by those linebackers.
Thank you so much, Duplantis Design Group. Edie White, 2nd and 7. We got to bite off a chunk of yards here on 2nd down, I think. Let's see what Edie White can do. Again, the athleticism of De La Salle is unbelievable. Inside handoff to Douglas, and he gets up to the original line of scrimmage. So 3rd and 7 upcoming for the Cards.
Yeah, again, the defense is stopping the Cardinals on more
ways than not.
White's
going quick here, Ben.
Well, they're lining up quick. They might look back at the coaches. We'll see. Nope. Pass.
Wide open, LaFon! Beautiful design play there.
Yes.
I like that.
Yeah, again, they roll him out to give him some time. Good blocking.
And a De La Salle defender is down again. He must be cramping up.
Good comeback catch there by Paxton for the first down there. That's a big play,
beautiful.
Rob.
Yeah, huge. First down. Thank you so much, Duplantis Design Group. The De La Salle player continues to be on the ground. Looks like they're stretching him out for cramps. I'm assuming they have to take a timeout there. No, Ben?
He's on the ground still. I see him.
I don't.
It might be the Fisher timeout, right?
I really,
because he's hurt.
Quite not clear on what the rules state there. I thought it.
No, if it's an injury, you get an official timeout.
Is that right? Okay.
Yeah. I mean, they could call a timeout too, but I think it's an official timeout.
Roger that. Okay, so E.D. White on the move. The De La Salle players cramping up a smidge. All right, and they get, I think that's 26, I think. Yep, 26. Walks off the field under his own power. Looks like they were just stretching his leg out. Edie White, 1st and 10 on the 31-yard line of De La Salle. Such an important series here. Oh, gosh.
Dang it.
Oh, face mask.
That's a big face mask.
Where's the flag?
Oh, they called it, right?
They did, yes. There's a flag.
Say,
that is
how
a
you
huge
face mask. His head around.
Yes.
Whoo, that's a big play. They had it for the sack.
Thankfully,
almost.
Jake's head is still on his shoulders.
Ooh, that could have hurt Jake there. Boy, he stumbled, and that guy kind of had him.
Yes.
And Jake got away, and he grabbed that face mask. Big play. This 15-yard is going to help a lot.
Yep, two big 15-yard penalties against De La Salle on this drive.
Jake looks okay, huh?
Yeah, he looks good.
Okay, all right.
All right, here we go, the step off. Oh, and that is a push them forward penalty.
Oh, Rob, this is nice. Two big penalties against De La Salle for 30 yards is helping this drive, I can tell you that.
And we've entered.
We needed it. Now we need a touchdown.
The Rico Red Zone. Thank you so much, Rico.
Oh, this could be a big momentum shift.
Edie White plays 1st and 10 on the 17-yard line.
Some reason the referee's over there talking to the Cavalier sidelines here.
Oh. Oh, are they telling him to get back? Is it a sideline? The coach, everybody got pushed back a little bit. I think we're in the same situation on our sideline. All right, here we go. 1st and 10 upcoming for the Cards. LaFont split out to the right. Guidry in motion. Oh, my goodness. Down goes Sternfels. No time for Sternfels. Yeah. There, unbelievable penetration by the defensive tackles for De La Salle.
All right, updated score. Assumption's now tied at 15 in their playoff game.
Loss of one on that play, actually, Ben. Second and 11 upcoming. Yeah, this defensive line has given Edie White's offensive line fits tonight. Sternfels under center. Sternfels wants to pass, Ben. Quick throw to LaFont. LaFont! Does he have it? Yes! Yes! Beautiful play by LaFont!
What a catch! He was all over
it! Throw it up and let him get it!
Goodness!
Beautiful play!
Number 20 was right on it. No difference. LaFont went up like a man and grabbed the ball right on his head.
That's a highlight play by LaFont. But look,
goodness gracious.
Put that ball up where only LaFont can get it.
Well, I don't know about that.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
It was a good pass. I'm not saying that, but
Ty Powell out. Kick is up, and it is good, TV.
Nice
job. So a few things we got to do there. Of course,
that's a
big, big
play.
We're happy to see
touchdown
the touchdown guy. He's not getting a lot of exposure tonight, but thank you so much,
touchdown guy. Look at that sexy man. I got to like that. Love it.
Thank you so much, touchdown guy. And, of course, Dr. Bo Porsche, she's got your back. Kick and punt sponsor, Homa Thibodaux Spine and Rehabilitation. Well, T-Ben, Edie White needed to answer all of those. How many unanswered points did we have there?
All of them.
It was
10-0, so all of them. 20 unanswered points.
Yikes.
And then now, that was big. I mean, we had two huge 30-yard penalties, which helped us. But that was a clutch passing catch by the Cardinals.
Well, we need to see if our defense can get a stop here.
Well, you figure this will fire him up for sure.
Yeah, with De La Salle's been hitting us on those deep balls.
With these high school kids, it's all about momentum.
Yep.
Short kick.
Short kick
weird.
By Ty. Uh-oh!
Why a short kick? I don't know.
A beautiful return by De La Salle. Gets up to midfield, tackled by Escher and Powell, the kicker. But a wonderful return. Gets it up near
That's
midfield.
That's some speed. Look at the speed.
Yeah.
Ooh, man. Oh, yeah. Kicker needed to help with that.
Yeah,
he might have broke that all the way.
Big
excellent
field position for De La Salle.
Yes, he's going to start almost at midfield here. All right. So that's not a good start, but let's see how we finish.
Three receivers split out for De La Salle. See if Arsenault is going to quick pass.
Wide open.
Slips and falls.
At about five.
5 yards. That's what you want. First and. Second and five upcoming for De La Salle. Edie White's playing off the receivers a bit.
Across midfield now in Cardinal territory.
The crowd's trying to come alive. Two receivers split out right, one left. Arsenault with the pitch out to number four.
Good blocking there. He
pulls
him off again.
He rips off 3 or 4 yards. It's going to be third and short upcoming.
Yep. Good tackle by Luke there. Yep. After you gain about 4 yards.
Yep. Four is having an impressive night, I'd say, for De La Salle, T-Ben.
Yes. Well, he had nice.
Luke Zerang, yep, on the tackle.
He had a lot of nice short runs in that one big run.
Third and two upcoming for De La Salle. I feel like this is a run here, Ben. Let's see if I'm right.
I think you're right, but we can get some penetration. We've got it before. Let's see.
The crowd comes alive. Arsenault calls for the ball, hands it off to four. First down.
He got it this time. Oh, it's close. He got it.
I don't know.
No, no. They marked him short. I thought he had forward momentum.
Well,
he's short.
It's fourth and one. I got to imagine coach for De La Salle is going to go for it.
Yeah, probably so. But goodness, that's a big stop. Taylor Thibodaux on the tackle, Rob.
Well, Arsenault checks out, T-Ben.
Oh, they're going to do Wildcat here.
Well?
With 4 and 8.
Well?
They're two big running backs. Yes, they're going Wildcat, Rob.
Wildcat.
Now, they're both good running backs here, so I don't know who called them
to
be on.
Stay home here.
Yep. 4th and 1. It's a big play. They're going to try to get penetration. Nope, he got it.
Ooh,
that's
he got it. Beautiful second effort
goodness,
by four. He's still going.
Nate runs him out of bounds.
Pushed him out after he got – 10 or 12 yards there. Beautiful design play.
Carter's tried to get penetration, but number four is just a man. Bounced off of that and got about a 10-yard gain for the first down. Ball, that was a big fourth down conversion. Now the Cavaliers set up all the way on the 32. This is going to be constant fourth down going for it, Rob. So we have to stop him for four downs here.
Arsenault checks back in the game with the first fresh set of downs. Calls for the ball. He's going to pass.
Beautiful pass.
Oh, in and out of the hands of the receiver. Oh, that was TD City, Ben. Drop ball by the receiver.
Number 14, Brant Haynes, who's been having a good night, dropped that ball.
Yeah, that was a beautiful pass by Arsenault on the money in stride.
Yeah, Luke was right behind him, but it was, like you said, it was dropped right in his hands. Big break for the Cardinals. That'll bring up a second down and 10. Well, we need a turnover or something here, Rob. Somebody needs to make a play. Hand off up the middle. Breaks it loose, number eight this time.
Looks like he got 7 yards. Nice run.
Kobe Pounds.
Third and
number eight.
Two or three upcoming. Well, they're saying third and four.
Yeah.
Upcoming. But as you mentioned, we're in four down territory.
Right. Well, you'd rather be third and four than not, so it's a big play here. You almost got to try to stop with no gain or less if you can. Again, I'm kind of hoping for a turnover. Maybe a fumble here would be nice. Interception, we'll see. They might just run it twice, though, Rob.
Yep. Arsenault calls for the ball.
They're going to
run it. Oh! Beautiful penetration.
33 again. Of course, 33.
Thibodaux.
Yeah, Thibodeaux's in the back.
Of course, beautiful penetration.
Now, he missed him and slowed him down.
He slowed him down.
Yep. And Todd Thibodaux came finish him off.
And, oh, the Thibodaux guys came in.
All right, now you got a fourth and five. This is a big play. They're going to go for it, though.
Yeah, I mean.
This is big. I mean, they just don't trust their kicker from that far. That's far for high school.
Right.
I mean, usually kickers in high school wait till you get to the 15.
Right.
We just lucky. All right, this is big, 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 big. Fourth and six, Rob.
Four receivers split out for De La Salle.
Get some pressure on them, guys.
Arsenault calls for the ball.
Get him.
He's being held! That's holding! Holding comes in, they'll wave it off and turnover
and
down.
Yes. Woo! That's a big play.
Big defensive stop. He was going to be sacked by Benoit.
Yep. Did they call the penalty? They're going to decline it.
Yeah, they declined it. So turnover on downs, that is huge, T-Ben.
Good play by the Cardinal defense. He had a little time, but nobody was open.
So
and
happy.
Benoit got in there.
So happy to have senior leader Noah Benoit back this week.
He's been injured all season.
Made some good penetration, and the offensive line had no choice but to hold him or the quarterback was going to get sacked.
And like I said, they had good coverage in the back because he had a little time and had nobody to throw to. So that was good job of the Carter defense all the way around. Big turnover now. Gives the Carters a chance here.
Yeah.
If we could get a drive like we got there last time, it would be awesome. Even if it's penalties again, I don't care. Get four penalties. Drive all the way down the field. This
all right,
is great.
Here we go. Let's see.
You almost think we got to start passing more.
LaFont split out left.
They've been keying on our run, King.
I sure like it when they would do those little flare passes out to LaFont. Pitch to
that's good blocking. Block.
Carter Douglas.
Block somebody.
Beautiful run by Carter. He gets 8 yards.
That's a good run. Good blocking.
Oh, we got another De La Salle player down. T-Ben number 20, injury timeout.
Oh, my goodness. He's not moving. Hope he's all right. Hey, he moves a little bit. Hope he's all right.
Yep. Let's see if it's cramps again. Oh, Paxton there to check in with him. Let's see. The trainer for De La Salle comes out. Hopefully everything's okay there. They're stretching him out. So De La Salle's suffering from some cramps here in the second half.
All right, Rob, got a couple more scoring updates. Lafayette Christian, 38, Peabody, 8 in the second quarter. I'm sure that's at halftime now. Assumption's retaking the lead, 22-15 over Brobridge in the third quarter. And it looks like your Pels are up 86-77.
Oh, over the defending champion, Denver Nuggets. Thank you so much, Jared. Good try, Jared. We're getting a giggle over here. Our friend who sends us the scores, everybody, tries to mix in some fake schools to see if we're paying attention. And sometimes we're like Ron Burgundy and just read whatever he texts. But anyway, it looks as if the De La Salle players just being stretched out. So that's good news.
Good.
Just having some cramps. We don't want anybody to get injured here.
When we come out of the timeout, we'll have a second and one.
Yeah, beautiful run by Douglas there.
Yes, yes.
Well, T-Ben, we knew this was going to be a slugfest tonight. I don't think anybody thought otherwise.
No.
De La Salle is a very accomplished team. Oh, coach is helping him off the field. And the trainer for De La Salle, number 20. Hope he's okay. And as you say, T-Ben, Edie White will have second and short. Well, can't do anything yet until coach and player clear the field. Play clock hasn't started yet, so Edie White will get a full 40-second play clock. LaFont split out left on the short side here. Edie White's going to run. Hand off to...
Oh, it's close. Let's see.
Douglas, not sure where the spot is. I'm looking at the official over there. Looks like it's going to be third and...
He didn't make that?
Well, I mean, the down guy changed it to first down, but I think it's... Is he moving the chains?
It looks like he made it, though, what his ball is. Yeah, it's a first down.
First down! Thank you so much, Duplantis Design Group. Right, T-Men?
Well, they spotted the ball. It's a first down. Unless the markers are in the wrong place.
Are they going to call for?
I mean, I'm looking at the marker. It's over there by the 38, and they marked the ball almost to the 39. I guess they're going to measure it.
Yeah, they're going to come out and measure it. So.
All right. Well, we'll see.
The officials are conferencing.
Nah, they're saying first down.
First down, Edie White. Thank you so much, Duplantis Design Group. Edie White with a much-needed first down.
Yeah, that's a good way to start it. First down.
For anybody joining us late in the broadcast, Rob Bauer, T-Ben Thompson here with a home broadcast for Edie White. So pardon our exuberance for the Cardinals, but we put on a free broadcast, so hopefully that offsets everything. De La Salle beating Edie White.
Ready for a pass play right now.
Hand off to Douglas. Not much doing if he didn't drop him for a loss there.
Douglas up the middle. He gains one.
1 yard, they're saying, for Douglas. Okay.
That was a tackle by number 6, Jace Bieniemy. He plays wide receiver. He must be playing both ways.
Oh, 20 comes back out, T-Ben. Happy to see that. I think he had just checked out with some cramps, so we're happy to see him check back in.
Yep, that's good. Oh, correction. I'm sorry. That's what was wrong. It's Troy Williams on the tackle there.
Nice play by Williams.
Yep.
All right. Ooh, Edie White's running up to the line. What do we do? We got two receivers split out. Michael Tinney back there. Jake drops back. He's got time. Throws it up to LaFont.
Nice catch. Way to track that in the air.
Oh, beautiful design play.
LaFont's making some pretty catches tonight.
He sure is.
What a job by passing.
And when you're out there one-on-one, that big 6'4" LaFont.
Yes. And look at that drop-in pass there by our quarterback Sternfels. He just kind of lofted it in that little empty zone right there.
First down.
And let his excellent senior wide receiver go get that ball.
Thank you so much, Duplantis Design Group. Edie White in De La Salle territory. Inside handoff to Douglas.
About a yard, 2 yards.
2 yards.
That's going to end the third quarter here. So the Cardinals
right,
on the move down, and going to be down 17-20 at
Thank
the
you
end
so
of the third
much
quarter.
To Claymore Family Dentistry for sponsoring the third quarter. And now we're into the Start of the fourth quarter. We'd like to thank Dr. Devin Bourgeois, Internal Medicine. Thank you so much. A new sponsor. Fourth quarter sponsor. Thank you so much, Dr. Devin Bourgeois, a new sponsor. And we've got another, looks like a stretching situation, some cramping going on by the De La Salle players, T-Ben. So we'll go ahead and take an opportunity to acknowledge some of our amazing shout-out sponsors. Dr. Bo Grafton, thank you so much, Dr. Bo Grafton in Cosmetic Surgery, home of Thibodaux, Morgan City, and Raceland. Will Abel, attorney at law. Personal injury and commercial work. Blake's Deli out on the bypass road. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. It's all great food at Blake's Deli. Aaron Rushing, Comprehensive Hearing Solutions. Thank you so much, Aaron. TEBT Contracting for all your general contracting needs. We'll go ahead and catch the rest of our shout-out sponsors here in a moment.
Yeah, the Cards had a drive going here, Rob. It's going to be second down and 8 inside of De La Salle's territory at the 40-yard line, or the 39 here.
Jake pitches it out to who we got here? Douglas for no gain, I think.
Uh-oh, Douglas might be hurt. Yep. Yeah, Douglas is standing on the ground.
Injury timeout.
Oh, my goodness.
I think they're stretching Carter out.
Oh, I hope you're right. Okay.
Yeah, they're stretching Carter out. So it looks
number
like everybody's
10, number
getting.
Number 10, Trish is coming in as fullback.
Yep, everybody's getting cramps here at the end of the game. T-Ben, I tell you what, during this injury timeout, we'll try to get some of our other folks in. Jeremy P. Robichaux. Attorney at law. Thank you, Jeremy. Popes for Parts in Thibodaux and Schriever for your auto and truck parts. Thank you so much, Pope for Parts. Rocco Dog Productions. Call 1-800-ROCCO-DOG for all your production needs. Thank you so much, Glenn Caillouette, a terrific supporter of E.D. White Athletics and former state champion when he played at E.D. White, T-Ben. Former longtime proprietor of Rox's Bar. Rocco is a Thibodaux icon, everybody. Terminex, Holma and Thibodaux. You know we got termite problems in South Louisiana. Call Terminex. Amplify Events, Sugar Plum Shindig, T-Ben, sponsored by Green Acres. It's located at the Rendezvous in Thibodaux on December 9th. Let me put that back up again. And December 10th, you can bring your kids there. There's gingerbread. Decorating, there's hot chocolate, there's mimosas for mom. It's a lot of great stuff. Check it out. Trent's Air Conditioning for all your heating and air conditioning needs. Thank you so much, Trent. And of course, T-Ben, Rouse's Market. Family owned and local since 1960. Thank you so much. Oh, and we want to take the opportunity to mention one of our very good friends, a former De La Salle alum, Theodore Newfield, 1996. De La Salle, great. Hopefully Ted's tuned in from South Florida. Here we go.
All right, big third down play here. Third down and 7 for the Cardinals. Face the short pass. Going deep.
Wide open, LaFont. Again! Oh, LaFont
nice
is
play.
Killing it
goodness
tonight.
Great. What a good throw that time.
Wow!
Oh, my goodness. Watch, he faked it short. And the fart burning
goes up, yep. And number one's down with cramps. Edie White's got it on the
look, he
1 yard
it.
Line. Dude,
what
I thought
a good play.
I thought that.
And look, they had pressure on him. Jake
throw it out on Font, and he goes and gets it. Edie yep. White first and goal
look,
from
Jake
the
is calm as a cucumber. He had pressure in his face, rolled out on the run, and made that throw. and they just burn him deep.
E. White on the 2-yard line.
Every time I watch the Funk catch, he looks so much bigger than the cornerback.
Yes.
He's just a big
kid.
Big wide receiver, yes.
Foster Porsche checks in on the left-hand side there. They're going to run
to the
left.
This is huge.
Two-point Treesh! Is he
in? Pushing him in!
Two-point Treesh!
Yes! That's a team touchdown there.
Beautiful! First push for two-point Treesh!
Jax keeps driving his feet, and they all push him in.
Love it!
Woo! That's the biggest tush push episode.
Look, T-Man, you know what time it is.
Oh, my favorite person.
It's Touchdown Guy time, everybody. Woo! Thank you so much, Touchdown Guy.
What resilience from the Cardinals.
High Tide Consulting. Goodness. Here goes Powell. Kick is up.
Oh, gosh.
And
that was
it
a great drive.
Good.
Yes.
So with 11 minutes left in the game, ladies and gentlemen, E.D. White retakes the lead.
Oh, wow.
And is up 24-20. This is by no means in the bag.
No.
As
well,
De La Salle
is a
very dangerous team.
Yes.
And the cramping has started, Ben.
Yeah, look, they're cramping
again. I'm so confused. I want a physical therapist or someone to explain this to me. When it's cooler, I guess it's just at the end of the game.
I don't know.
I thought cramping was more or less like a when you're dealing with super high temperatures.
I'm gonna tell you what. I was very nervous with how well the De La Salle defense was shutting down our running game. Well, not shutting it down, but impeding our running game.
Oh, that's number 9.
That we would have a hard time. But I tell you what, the Cardinals stepping up and the passing game, Jake and Paxton and the rest of the guys in the offensive line. Very impressive to answer and take the lead. Again, the game's not over. It's far from over. But just to come back and take the lead again is impressive.
Well,
I'm
they were
very,
down by 10.
Impressed. Yes. And we just had 14 points unanswered, Rob. You got to love it.
Yeah. Well, the crowd has come alive. So the crowd is back in the game for sure.
Yes.
And how about 2-point Treesh jumping in there and filling in for Douglas, who was out?
All right, here's the big kickoff. I'm assuming this time he's going to kick it out of the back of the end zone since that short kick didn't work out too well.
Big kick by Powell out of the end zone. Beautiful kick by Powell. Big shout-out, T-Ben, to the Lerettes. Big Joe Lerette and Riley Bailey watching from Dolphin Island, Alabama.
Awesome.
Big Joe's Joni's boy.
Yeah, nice.
Former E.D. White, great. And Riley was our awesome statistician.
Yes.
Say that twice last year.
Hope they're having a good time, man.
And Dolphin Island. Thank you all so much.
All right, scoring update, St. James 35, North Webster 6. And the Pels got a close game here, 95-92.
All right, here we go, T-Ben. Three receivers split out. Hand off to number 4. Moving those legs.
Powerful
He's hard to bring down. He gets 6 or 7 yards there. Nice run by number 4. Yep.
Gain about 7-8 yards there. That'll bring up a second down at 3.
Oh, gosh, we forgot the Rico red zone. I'm so sorry, Ron. We were in the Rico red zone. Thank you, Ron, for the reminder.
Did you do the kicking sponsor?
No, I got to get that, too. I'm sorry.
Here we go.
Second down and three. Three upcoming.
He's going to pass.
Deflected at the line of scrimmage. I'm not sure who got their hand on that. Let's see if we can figure it out.
Nice play. Yeah, I didn't see who it was either, but that's a good play.
They said Sternfels.
Oh, yep.
46.
46, the linebacker.
Yep.
Nice play there. That'll bring up a third down, Rob. Third down and 3. Big play again. If the Cardinals get the ball right back,
well,
that'd be great.
It's like Charlie defense wants the blitz there.
The quarterback has made a change at the line of scrimmage, probably a run play. Let's see.
Pitched
it outside. Oh, he broke the tackle.
They got it. God. First down.
Diggity dog.
First down. Nice play by De La Salle to get the first down. That pitch, little pitch out to number 8. And he gets more than what he needs and gets a first down.
Number 33 with the tackle there at the end.
That's Thibodaux.
Big third down conversion there.
Yep.
For the Cavaliers, that'll bring up, give them a first down at the 35-yard line.
Hand off to number 4.
tackled by a flock of Cardinals, but after a five-yard gain.
Yes, they had him bottled up. Yeah. He is a strong runner.
Yes, churning those legs.
As Jason Banks, the main running back, has been having a good night, as you said earlier. All right, second down and four. The running game of the Cavaliers.
Oh, he wants a pass. Two-point reach! Cash with the sack. Just scored a touchdown and a nice sack by number 10.
Boy, nobody blocked him.
Locked him up. Oh, he dug Evan down. Beautiful play by two-point reach on there. Big shout-out to Benton LeBlanc.
Nice job by Jax.
This is a first, T-Ben. 30,000 feet above America. He is in a plane and streaming us. So.
Oh, wow. Jack scores the touchdown. It comes back with the big sack. How do you like that for a game?
Dude, third and 10.
Nice job,
Treesh. Uh-oh, come on. Get with it.
Oh, now don't
secondary.
Get the long third down conversion. Come
get
on,
with it, secondary.
Get in there. Get in there. Go deep.
Oh, no.
Somebody got to be there. How is he open again?
Wide open, number five.
God bless America.
Catches the ball.
He's open, wide open. Ugh. We have big play, reception by number five. That's Jace Benamy, the senior wide receiver, with the catch there, but a 30-yard catch for the first down. That'll put the Cavaliers in E.D. White territory all the way down to the 32-yard line. We've got a timeout here, I think by the Cardinals. Not quite sure, but there's definitely a timeout. Again, that was a big third down conversion, and somehow coverage got mixed up, and number five was wide open down the middle of the field. So the De La Salle offense will set up shop in Cardinal territory when we come out of this break here. All right, scoring update, Shaw 17, Evander 13 in the fourth quarter. Assumption 29, Brobridge 15.
Wow, good go Mustangs.
And St. Thomas More 35 and Struma 8.
Choo, St. Thomas More.
All right, here we go. First down after that big play. See if the Cardinal defense can stiffen up.
First and 10, what are we thinking, Ben? Hand off to number four? Hand off to number five. Oh, good blocking there.
Yep, and a good cut up the middle.
A beautiful run, a well-designed play by De La Salle for a big gain. And they're at the E.D. White, like, 15-yard line. So De La Salle on the move.
Yeah, that was another big play there, back-to-back.
All right, Arsenault ready for the ball. Calls for the ball, hands it off to number four.
Oh, wow. Breaking tackles.
Wow.
Breaking four tackles all the way
down to
the 1 yard line.
To the 1 yard line. Powerful running by number four.
Oh, I thought they had him at the line.
Yeah.
Right there, and then breaking tackles. Wow.
Man, breaking he's
more
strong.
Tackles.
Yep.
Goodness gracious.
Nearly gets it in the end zone. Down first and goal on the 1 yard line for De La Salle.
All right, first down at the 1 yard line.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa! Flags everywhere.
Ooh, that's going to help.
Yep.
That'll make a first and six.
They did the old Wildcat maneuver there, too, Ben.
Yeah, it worked for them last time.
All right, that's a penalty. Thank you so much, Go Waste, for your season long sponsorship of our penalties. North America's top construction dump waste company. Thank you so much, 4A Brothers proprietor. All right, T-Ben, first and goal from the six-yard line now. That didn't help their cause. Arsenault back in at quarterback. Arsenault wants to pass, throws it in the... Oh! Wide open. Gosh. Wide open, 17, woo, touchdown. Woo.
I'll be back. Number 17 is wide open in the corner for the touchdown. So the Cavaliers are going to retake the lead here. And we're waiting on the extra point with 7 minutes left. This is a heavyweight fight here. Both teams throwing big punches, taking the lead, taking the momentum. And now the visiting team is going to take the lead. 27-24 after that converted extra point. So again, the Cardinals are going to get the ball down by 3 points with 7 minutes left in this big playoff game here in Thibodaux. Got a shout out for Aaron Pico's friend, Tyron Morgan, who's in Houston turning in, saying he's having a good time listening to the broadcast. We want to welcome you, Tyrone, to the broadcast. Okay, it's all on the line now for the Cardinals. After their wonderful undefeated season and number 2 seed in the playoffs, it's all going to come down as its last 7 minutes of the game. Cardinals have 89 Nakan and number 9 Guidry back to receive the kick. Another big pooch kick. It's going to be short, and Cardinals going to have good field position. Number 4 runs up and catches it. Luke Zerang catches it on the run, making a big move, running up the field, breaking tackles, and he gets all the way down to the 34-yard line. What an awesome play by Luke Zerang, even to catch that ball. Look at that spin move. Tight rope down to the sideline without going out of bounds. Makes a big run, breaking tackles. Nice, strong move by Luke. Great play. Big momentum shifter there by Luke to get the Cardinals in great field position after just losing the lead. That is big time play by Luke Zerang. Nice job. Now the Cardinals can be all fired up as they come to the line of scrimmage. Start off at the 34-yard line, deep, deep in De La Salle territory. Oh, this is a big, big series here. This is nice. What a good return. And Luke's been doing that all season. He catches the ball in traffic. He's fearless and makes something happen. That's a great job by the junior cornerback, Luke Zerang.
Oh, offsides. On.
Yeah, that's going to back us up. Oh, somebody's helmet came off.
But that's 55. Hudson on cow.
So he's got to come out, I guess. All right, let's get back him up 5 yards here. First down and 15 now for the Cardinals. All right, here comes the Cardinals at first and 15.
Taylor up top. Oh, God,
oh, no.
Get on that ball.
Oh, no. Oh, my gosh.
Choo!
That's a big loss. I'm glad he got on it, but yeah. It's still almost a 20-yard loss.
Oh, that sucks.
That's going to bring up a second down and long, very long. They tried a little reverse play, a little reverse action to catch the Cavaliers offsides and over-pursuing, hopefully, and just lost the handle on that pitch and lost the ball. And heads up play to at least fall on it, but that's going to bring up a second and 30. Second and 26 for the Cardinals. Maybe try to get half of it back here.
Throws it up to LaFon again! No flags! No flags! Noel defended. Defended.
They had two defenders on him, and LaFon couldn't get away from both of them.
The crowd wants a...
Chet got hit right when he let go of the ball. I mean, not Chet, I'm sorry. Sternfels got hit right when he let go of the ball.
A little underthrown there. Well defended by De La Salle.
Yeah, he almost couldn't step into it, though. They were hitting him right as he threw it, so...
Third and a mile upcoming for the Cards, T-Ben.
Yeah. Jake was trying to do the best he could there, and then there was a little pushing and shoving, but it's hard to call that when they hit double coverage on him.
So what's going on here?
I don't know, but the De La Salle players on the sideline are getting all fired up. Third 26 here.
Timeout, Edie White.
Yep, timeout, Edie White. All right, big third down at 26. I don't know what they could do here. Let's see what they got.
They're bringing LaFont back to the right-hand side. Two receivers split out left, LaFont right, Jake in the shotgun. Got to give him some protection, everybody. Give him some protection. Throws it up to who? That was just a –
Yep. On a different page there.
Right, here comes our punter, Ty Powell. So under 6 minutes to go, ladies and gentlemen.
You try to pin him deep and
get a defensive stop. And you got two timeouts left.
They could do it. They're going to have to be geared up to stop number four.
Powell kicks it.
Hopefully got extra high.
See if he can get a good bounce. It takes a Cavalier bounce. It's out. 19 yard line.
Yeah. All right, first down and 10. Season on the line here with just 5 minutes and 51 seconds left. Cardinals almost got to force a three and out. Maybe you can afford to give up one first down and still get the ball back with about 2 minutes. But really, you almost need to get them to have a three and out here. It'd be a big play. I'm assuming they're going to try to run the ball. And the second half, we'll be kind of wearing down. And number four has been pounding on us. In the backfield. So here come the Cavaliers, first down. Hand off to number four, right up the middle. This time they bottled him up.
He got a yard?
He still falls forward. Yep, got about a yard, maybe a half a yard.
And that clock is ticking.
Yep, good play by the Cardinal defense. You needed to do that at least, so that'll bring up second down and 10. So, I don't know. I'm not sure. They're going to just keep running the ball and let the clock run and give us the ball back, or they're going to try for a first down pass. You got to be ready for anything at this point. Like you said, if they get a first down, it would be very hard. It's going to run a lot of time off the clock. Big second down here.
Jack Streich looking like he wants.
Oh, high snap. Pitch to number four.
A loss on the play, T-Ben.
That was awesome.
Third and 13 upcoming. Two-point Trish is down. Let's see. He's
Thibodaux.
Cramping.
Thibodaux with the awesome read here, Rob.
Jax is cramping up. The cramps have set in, Ben.
That's the way he stopped number four. Before he gets going, Thibodaux gets him down to the ground. And that loses 2 yard drive. That's going to be a big third and 12 here. You're right, Rob. Both teams are cramping up. It's a phenomenon going on here.
Phenomenon.
All right, so third and 12, big play. Again, our defense does good, and then they give it these big third downs. got some busted coverages in the secondary, which have hurt us. Number four had some big runs. This is a huge play. It's almost a must-have play. So this is an official timeout, correct, Rob?
With the I would cramp? Think so. Yeah, I mean, there was a handful of official timeouts when LaSalle was cramping.
So. Yes, it must be the same. So LaSalle's going to get the ball, and they're going to start the clock back, and I'm sure they're going to run some more time off because that's what they're going to want to do before they run this third down play.
Still stretching Jacks out. All right, a big thanks to Devin Bourgeois, our fourth quarter sponsor, Internal Medicine. Thank you so much, Devin. Thanks to all of our sponsors tonight for your support of ED White Athletics tonight and all season long to all the season long sponsors.
All right, updated score. Turlings 24, Ashley Madison 14, which would have been a big score for us to keep track of. Of course, it might not matter soon if we don't do something in the next 5 minutes. But. That's a correction. That's Madison Prep there. Good job, Stogie.
Jared, you've outdone yourself, my friend. Anyway, Jax is coming off. I think they had to stretch Jax out. He's coming off.
Okay, here we go. Huge play for the whole season almost. Third down and 12. This is big, big, big. Somebody needs to make a big play here for the Cardinals.
Dylan Robichaux.
He's going back to pass.
Yes,
no flags.
Yes.
Oh, that's a big play.
Ooh, the receiver slipped.
Yes,
man.
He did. But
Escher was giving him good coverage.
Yep.
So here comes out the punting.
Yeah, that's not a penalty. He fell down. All right,
ooh,
great play. Oh, my gosh. What an ending this is going to be. This is going to be an ending here, Mr. Bauer. Oh, I need my heart pills.
113-110 Pels. I don't know how much time is left.
All right, Stogie, you've been cut off. I'm not reading any more of your scores.
some shout-outs. Bart Freeman, Sean Babin, Derek Atkins. Those are all good people.
All right, stop all that, Rob. Four minutes left. Let's concentrate on football. 4 minutes, 47 seconds left.
Punt is off. It's short. Oh. Get away.
No. Luke does a great job every time.
Beautiful return, Luke.
Good job.
To the 25-yard line.
Don't ever tell Luke to not catch the ball. He's going to catch the ball in traffic.
I'm sorry.
In traffic every
Luke
time.
Luke knows better than I do. Look at that. That kid has got guts,
he
man.
Does.
Wow.
Luke Zering has instinct and has been doing it all year long. He's a great player.
Oy.
Big momentum changer for the Cardinals on offense and defense. Well, special teams and defense. Luke does it all. Woo! Good job by Luke. Look what we're setting up, Rob, on the 26. This is it. This is it. All or nothing. This is fourth down territory.
By that
oh, that's true. He's tied with a field goal even. Not, well, I don't even think like that, but I'm just saying.
Shush.
Well, okay. Anyway, we all set right. up pretty good.
LaFont and Guidry split out right. Do we pass first down? Let's pass first down. Jake keeps it.
Jake! To the 11-yard line. What a
see
good
that
job.
Again.
Woo!
Our senior quarterback.
He found it. Nice job by the Cardinals. That's a big, big
first
play.
First down, and we're in the red zone on a what? Ron texted me. I'm sorry, Ron.
Now you let the clock run down as much as you can, and run your plays.
Design group.
Oof. Oh my gosh, what a play by our senior quarterback! Good blocking by the offensive
and
line there.
And they've really given him fits all night with that play.
Oh my goodness.
I don't know who's got the ball there, Ben.
That was Carter Douglas right at the middle for about 2 yards. Wait, they're saying they have the ball, but they're not giving them the fumble. De La Salle came out of the pile with the ball. They're very upset. They think they had a fumble there. But no call by the ref, so the Cardinals will retain possession.
Oh.
I think he got about 2 yards there. It'll be about second down and 8. Well, I'm going to tell you, Rob, I know that there's a hard time getting an ambulance out of here. And if I have a heart attack, I'm going to have to. I give y'all permission to bring me by yourself. You can bring me to the hospital.
I will push you over the side.
Just right, jump me over.
Here we go. Oh, my goodness. What we got?
Second and eight. Yes, from the 9.
And the clock is ticking.
Let it tick.
Well, I don't know about all that.
Why wouldn't you want the clock to tick?
Because we don't want a field goal. We want a touchdown.
I want the clock to end points. You want him to come down and score?
3rd and 9 upcoming for the Cards.
Yes. This is huge. I would love for him to get a touchdown. But you still let that clock keep ticking is all I kept telling you. Whew, big play. I think at this point they might pass it even. I was saying run it every time, but I don't know what they're going to do.
What we got? Timeout? Timeout.
Who?
Them. Yeah, De La Salle wants to talk about it.
Well, why didn't he do that 20 seconds ago? That didn't make any sense. But anyway, all right. Timeout, De La Salle, on a 3rd and 8 from the 9-yard line.
All right, here we go. Let's set the scene. They've isolated LaFont here, 1-on-1. Whoa. What we got here?
They stopped the play. I don't know if it was a penalty or a timeout. Penalty.
Penalty on who?
Us. If they stopped the play, it's on us.
Oh.
I mean, usually, unless it was – it's.
No, it's a penalty against them.
It's all offsides, Rob.
Oh, wow.
No, that's not a first down. It's be 5 yards. It's going to be
Yeah, but that's still big.
Well, it's going to be 3rd and 5. It is big. I mean, it's better than a penalty against us. Gee, but
ye of little faith.
Let's see. What are they talking about? I mean, you kind of tipped your hand and you would have lobbed it up to Paxton. So you're not going to do that play. So what are you going to do at 3rd and 5? No foul now, they call. Inadvertent whistle. Now our coach is going crazy here. Oh, they picked up the flag, Rob, and they didn't let they took away our play because now the lob to the Paxton is gone. I guess you can still try it, but they're probably going to double team him now. Well, I don't even understand what they called. If it's offsides, it's offsides. How do you pick the flag up? What was the call? Oh, I think they're saying they had 12 men in the field. That wouldn't be a 5-yard penalty. That'd be a first down. If that's what the call was.
They picked it up.
But they picked it up. Well, that's probably why he's so mad. That would have been a first down if it was a 12 men in the field. Oh, my goodness. Well, they explained it to him. They're not going to back down. That's it. It's going to be 3rd down and 9. So the Cardinals are going to lose out on that battle. Still a big play. And, again, you want to at least be able to tie the game. We hope to be able to score the touchdown. Obviously.
Oh, I don't know, T-Ben. They're still conferring.
I've never seen him wave the flag and go back. This would be amazing if Kyle could have convinced him to backtrack again.
I have heard your argument, Coach, and I agree with you.
Yeah.
You make perfect sense.
Have you ever heard that? Ever?
No.
No, me neither. But, boy, they're talking about it.
They sure are.
This is amazing.
I think they're talking about Huddle House or –
Yes.
Waffle House. I'm trying to make it.
Can you believe this coach?
Right, hold on. What's he doing?
Well, you got to watch his signals. Let's see. He's going to make some signals here.
Yes!
Give it to
us. Yes, Kyle!
It was offside. It's not a first down.
Okay, it's not a first down, but Kyle is one heck of a litigator.
That is true. It's just, but it's a 3rd and 5.
Call the law firm of Kyle Lissay.
All right, so you get a 3rd and 5 here. And now the – I guess can you still try to lob it to Paxton?
I mean,
I got to see what kind of defense they got.
Thinking that he'd go back to the well a second.
Well, you
time.
Will if they leave that one guy out of there.
It's 3rd and Five from the – what are we on, the five?
From the six.
Oh, third,
third five from the five. Anyway, are they leaving one guy in Paxton again? No, we're not isolating them this time, Rob. We're doing something
right.
Different. I don't know what we're doing.
I don't know either. But we're going to run it to the left-hand side.
I
we're going to bring still, everybody to the right-hand
I
side. We're
still
going
to
do something left-hand side. Watch, Steven.
You're probably right, but I'd lob it to Paxton again anyway.
Here we go. Jake rolls out.
They are doing it.
Touchdown!
That's
touchdown!
Oh, my gosh. What a game.
Paxton. Pass by Jake.
He gunned it in there. Caught it.
Wow!
What a game from Paxton LaFont. He is having a game of his life in the playoffs.
Incredible!
You know, that's awesome. If you're a senior and you don't want to lose and go home, that's how you play the game. Paxton is dominating this game.
Kick is up and it's good. So
woo!
Let me tell you, my friend.
Oh, my God. This game is incredible.
All right. We did Red Zone. Thank you so much,
gosh.
Rico. Red Zone.
I can't even think straight right now.
And, of course, the touchdown guy. Thank you so much, Shang Yu and High Tide Consultants. Call High Tide Consultants for all your consulting needs. And, of course, Bo Porsche, Dr. Bo Porsche, he's got your back. Home of Thibodaux Spine and Rehabilitation. Thank you so much, Dr. Bo. Well, goodness gracious, T-Ben, 2:32. That's an awful lot of time left for De La Salle.
Yes, it does seem like a lot of time, especially with the heart attack I have going on. That's unbelievable. Oh, my gosh. This is the game of the century. This is awesome. And I don't want it to be better. I want it just to be it. This is good. We don't need another score. We don't need another we don't need any more drama. This has been great. Let's just.
Pels win 115-110.
Oh, my gosh.
Thank you, Craig Knockhand. Here we go. Ty Powell. Ty Powell kicks it out of the end zone.
That's what you want.
Yeah. Here's what you want. All right. Edie White up by four. De La Salle's got a whole lot of time left, ladies and gentlemen, and they have two timeouts.
Look, it's a team game. The pass of the Fawn has carried the offense tonight.
Well,
it is unbelievable.
Somebody's got to get him
the ball. I'm not saying that, but a good God, they know he's getting the ball. They know he's getting the ball, and it don't matter.
Yes.
He is dominant. I am impressed.
But Jake rifled that ball in, huh, T-Ben? That was awesome.
Yes, that was awesome. Look.
Uh-oh, here we
Nichols
go.
Nichols is getting to play, my guy.
Yes, that's right.
Jesus.
Nichols
Lord.
Commit. Woo. Here we go. Let's get some pressure on Arsenault here.
Please, get on him.
Woo, that's deflected by who? Trotty?
That could have been Trotty. One of the two. Watch. If Trotty did it again, that's a great play. Let's see. Yeah, look, he's
Trotty.
Trotty. It was Trotty. What? You saw him what read his eyes?
Yes, Dikembe Mutombo. Shake
it out of here.
Here we go.
Oh, my God.
Second and 10, like hardly.
Oh,
any
wait. Why we substituted somebody?
Jax Treesh off. Quick pass.
Oh, going deep. Nope, short.
14.
Caught it that time. Yeah.
Well defended by Nate Dogg Thompson.
All right, that's Brad Haynes with the catch there for how many yards, Rob?
He nears 7 yards. Steven Shaw wins.
Third and three, Rob.
Third and three. We need a turnover here. Here
Clock
we go.
Clock is kicking. They far away from the end zone. Don't let him get anything deep. Please, no, not number four. Come on, Tucker! Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
Wow. What a run by number four. Tackled finally by Luke Moran.
Oh, my gosh, they had him.
Yep.
Right here. Two of them.
Look. Oh, a nice spin God, move. He kept those legs moving. I'm not sure. Timeout by somebody here.
Thank God, Luke. De La Salle.
Timeout, De La Salle.
Well, now you're
155.
I was going to say it was a long way to go 40 yards ago before he makes that run. Oh, my gosh. Woo, yeah, number four has some yards now. He's over 100. He's been having a night. And usually so well tackling. And he is breaking the tackles, but we're also making missed tackles. Very unusual.
Well, good. We'd like to thank everybody who's tuning in from around Louisiana. I'm Rob Bauer, and this is my broadcast partner, T-Ben Thompson. We're two dads. Our two sons play for Edie White, so we're very enthusiastic about Edie White. It's the home broadcast. But De La Salle is giving Edie White everything they could handle tonight. A very good team, a very well-coached team.
Everybody's tuning in from around the world, Robbie.
Yes, well.
Oh, my gosh.
De La Salle's on the move.
First down.
De La Salle is on the move.
Right past midfield.
Arsenault's going to want to pass.
Throw.
Quick
sharp
pass
to 14.
Complete. That's almost a first down.
Yep. 8 yards, 9 yards. Out of bounds, stops the clock. Everything you want for De La Salle. Second down and two. Oh, this is definitely going to be one of these finishes.
Terling's 31, Madison Prep 24. Not sure if that game's over.
All right, might not matter, Rob.
I'm just announcing scores.
All right.
Four receivers split out for De La Salle. They need to get some pressure on Arsenault.
Oh, through his hands.
In and out of the hands of number five. Stops the clock with 1:47.
That's Jace Bieniemy again, Rob, number five. He could have caught that. Decent coverage by Michael John, but that was a very good pass right in his hands. Third and two now. Again, the clock stopped again. Need a sack here.
Or a turnover.
A turnover would be better, but a sack would at least run the clock and make them lose some yards. Third and short. They got to get the first down. They want to get the first down, Rob. So they probably figured they could go for something short. Run again.
Kept those legs running. First down. Beautiful run by number eight
this time. That is Kobe Pounds again with the first down run. That's going to stop the clock momentarily. But it's going to start running as soon as they set the ball, Rob.
The clock is running.
It is running?
The clock is running.
Well, first down, you're supposed to stop the clock. That's what the refs all get.
Well, here we go. They get up to the line.
Yeah, the clock ran the whole time. That's all right. That's good. Anyway, quick pass.
Oh, in and out. Oh, five's got the dropsies of late. Yep. Stops the clock with 1:22. Oh, my gosh, D-Ben.
The drama.
It is the drama. This game has been so drama-filled.
All right, this makes up for the whole season where we had to just fill in with all the blowouts. Yes. This is like unbelievable game.
I never got
game.
To say what a group of Cavaliers was.
What is that?
It's a court.
It's
or a cavalcade.
Cavaliers is a debutante.
I looked this up already.
Oh, you
here
did?
We go.
What is it?
What all right,
anyway,
it?
Stop talking about all this stuff. Come on, get here. Holden. Oh, no, he's open.
Woo. Incomplete pass, T-Ben.
Third down and 10. What?
A group of Cavaliers is a court.
A Cavalier is like a soldier, right?
I looked this up.
What is a Cavalier?
A Cavalier is a French aristocrat.
Right.
That's right.
But a soldier aristocrat or just an aristocrat?
Well, he has a cool plume
and
a sword.
You bring up this useless stuff
I'm
right
sorry.
Now.
I needed to get it out.
Right in the middle of this.
Third and 10.
Oh, my God, Robbie Bauer. All right, third and 10.
Oh, get some pressure on this guy. Oh, he's got all
shish kebabs.
Just picked off the
oh
pass.
My
where are you going tomorrow,
gracious.
T-Ben, where are you going tomorrow?
Go to Disney World!
Right,
we
T-Ben,
really are going to Disney World! Oh my God!
Wow!
Are we, oh my God!
Are we in victory?
I can't believe
T-Ben.
It.
T-Ben!
They only have one timeout, Robin. It's over. It is over! They're going to win the game, Robin! Oh, my God.
Who's a dummy now for saying
I can't
court?
Even take this. Oh, my God.
They took the timeout or no? They're not going to take the timeout.
Oh, my God. It doesn't matter.
It's wow. Over.
Oh, my God.
Unbelievable. T-Ben.
Oh, my God.
What a play by Nate Dogg. Jump that pass route. Goodness gracious.
Oh,
what
a way to step
about?
Up.
Victory! Come on!
This has been a topsy-turvy, upside-down game, Mr. Bauer. Kudos to the Cavaliers.
Yes.
Great effort. I mean, my goodness. It's a shame anybody
lose. Wow,
that awesome game.
Unbelievable, and your EDY Cardinals.
Oh, my God.
Win in the regional playoffs, T-Man.
Unbelievable!
Wow, wow, wow!
Unbelievable! Oh. Well, thanks to everybody who tuned in. De La Salle was an incredible opponent.
Great effort by those kids.
Edie
I mean,
White
that was amazing.
Did not give up, T-Ben. They no. 20 points that they, De La Salle reeled off.
Yes.
Had were, all yeah. the momentum going yeah. into halftime and coming out.
Yes, yes.
And Edie White did not give up. And Paxton
LaFont. I was going to say, Paxton LaFont. I got to pound the table. Paxton, 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 Paxton. Unbelievable. Luke, I mean, Jake.
Jake.
Jake. With everybody. Offensive line. But look, Jake and Paxton. Oh, my God. It's unbelievable. The offense, they were jumping our runs and impeding our running game all night. And we passed on them. And Jake was able to do it. And Paxton dominated. Dominated.
Incredible, T-Ben.
And, oh, my God.
T-Ben, you and I have been very fortunate to be a part of some incredible moments here at Edie White, and this ranks right at the top. De La Salle was no pushover opponent, a very battle-tested, as the coach said earlier in his interview, opponent, and Edie White prevails.
Well, look, I'm going to say this, though. I'm going to correct you one thing. This year, we had no good games to call. They were horrible.
Well, we destroyed Sam Houston them. Was a good game.
Which one?
Sam Houston.
It was all right.
anyway,
this one was awesome.
Yes. Wow. The kids are fired up. I think, T-Ben.
They should be fired up. That's an awesome game.
I think that we're very fortunate. I don't feel like we had any significant injuries. I know we had a lot of
cramping. Offense, defense, all up and down. They didn't give up when they had bad plays. Luke Zerang with the special teams. Our punter, kicker, the offense, the lines, dude. But, I mean, they all had good and bad plays, but they overcame it. I mean, it was perseverance at home by the Cardinals.
Wow. And, T-Ben, this is where home field advantage comes into play.
Oh, yes.
And having this seed and having this crowd keep our team uplifted.
Wow.
So we're going to go ahead and
So this magical season continues.
Yes.
Undefeated, number two-ranked Cardinals get to keep the home field playoff run alive.
The day after Thanksgiving.
Yes.
We don't know who yet, I don't think. But
no, but it looked like, it was close. But now you can start looking at the scores.
All right.
Sterling's and who are they playing? Ashley Madison.
Madison Prep. All right. Good job, Stogie. You got one through on TV.
Bye, everybody.
All right. Hold on. We're going to take a pause.
Okay.
And we're going to let our we're going to take in some sights and sounds of our friends singing the alma mater.
I'm not coming back. Bye.
Thank you.
was so excited. All right, everybody, I'm still with you. T-Ben's getting oxygen right now. But this was just an incredible, incredible game tonight. And big props to De La Salle and their coaching staff and everybody involved at De La Salle coming down here from New Orleans and playing their hearts out and giving just an incredible challenge to Edie White. And fortunately, Edie White was able to prevail. Looks like Turlings is on top 31-30. I'm not sure if that's over yet, but whoever. We're going to play whoever we're going to play next week. We can't worry about that right now. We got to take this victory in for Edie White. And we're going to have a day or two off, and then Edie White will be back to practicing next week during the holiday. And we'll be back here on Friday playing whoever we're playing. I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in tonight to our little broadcast. And we're so proud of our Cardinals as they continue this incredible season. And Coach Kyle and his staff, incredible job. Hats off to them. We're going to go and go ahead and end this broadcast. And thanks, everybody, for tuning in. And we'll see you next week.